holy calamity, scream insanity. Or are you ever going to be another great fan of me?
Welcome, baby.
Oh my God, welcome.
Look, this is episode 100, people.
We in here.
This is the open micers. We in this bitch, baby.
The centennial episode.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
A lot of people said we wouldn't make it to this. And by a lot, I mean, I don't think many people even knew we have a podcast, but
my brother didn't start listening until like Daniel White's episode.
I think my grandma mom started listening like by episode like 4. Like they were immediately like, huh, what is this? Yada yada. Like definitely, like especially because I was in college, they were like, I don't know if they thought this was like a school project or something. You know what I mean? But our guest today, like you've already seen in the description, Armondo Collins, welcome.
Hey, what's going on, everybody?
Dude, this is incredible. We had Armando on. We actually recorded an episode before this, but it got lost in the wayward.
Yeah, wayward. The ether.
Yeah, so that shit was too hot. But Armando, you've been, our most recurring guest. Always happy to catch up with you. I'm trying to think. Do you remember what was going on last time we talked to each other?
The last time we were talking about Trump shenanigans.
Yeah, I think it was like the first update. But then also, I think the last one was with Phil. I think that was with Phil.
With Phil. And I was actually, you guys, I mean, no disrespect to your show. I'm kind of sad Phil isn't here.
Okay, no, I respect that.
I can't afford it.
Yeah, Phil.
I can't afford
Phil
it.
Phil is his
up.
Own time zone.
Phil, honestly, if you're listening, we didn't even think to hit you up. I mean, honestly, it didn't even cross our minds, but I would like an update.
But
on
the
Phil.
Last episode, I haven't seen the Phil last episode, I just asked Phil to keep it together. That's not even, that's regular
and
shit.
And honestly, he did the exact opposite. He was like, keep it together, more mushrooms right here
I
at
said,
the table.
Keep it together,
live.
Phil. This man is eating a bag of mushrooms, psychedelic mushrooms, in Armando's face.
Yeah, as he Armando's like making a point.
As he's Armando's like, talking that good shit.
He's like arguing with Armando as he's like eating mushrooms, already high on mushrooms.
He enhanced the conversation.
Yeah. That was definitely an interesting one. That was, we might have to, all right, that might be a first little plug. We'll fucking drop like some heat from that episode, but that was a good one. We're definitely glad to have you back on. So the biggest thing that I mean, we can talk about whatever, but definitely anytime some shit goes on in the world, I'm like, I can't wait to hear what Armando has to say about this. We're probably, what would you say, 2-3 weeks removed from Charlottesville?
Yeah, probably less than a month. And as a matter of fact, I just actually did a lecture about that. Like, it was a panel discussion on white supremacy in the academy. It was UNCG's, faculty response to Charlottesville.
Okay.
Like, what does this reality mean for our campus, and how do we feel, and how would we respond? And of course, everybody is up in arms and against it.
Sure.
But very few people are prepared to go far enough as saying that, oh, that could be here. All they did was just choose a different location.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And historically,
yeah,
Greensboro has been a hotbed of racism and racist activity.
Oh, definitely.
Klan activity.
Yeah.
And any institution of higher ed right now can, or better yet, has those racist elements bubbling in them. Like, those people were everyday people.
Yeah. I think that was the most surprising part. I remember the night before, I mean, I'm on Twitter and stuff, and they just kind of joke. They're with these tiki torches and yada yada yada. I'm just like, where are all these dudes coming from? Because there was a different look about them.
There wasn't like,
why'd you say the hospital?
Firehouse subs. I'm just saying, like, they around.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, right.
Like, automobile. These niggas are here.
I mean, people were making fun of them that they had khakis on and collared shirts, but really they were like the clean cut. Not there was not an explicit down home Southern Confederate vibe. It was the more modern. This it's like how we're repurposing white nationalism. You know what I mean?
What they showed you is that the stereotype of the white nationalist, the poor white trash, backward, uneducated, fringe crazy.
Yeah,
that's only one aspect of that whole thing. It's actually much deeper, more deeply entrenched in society.
Yeah.
What you saw was, as a matter of fact, one of the reoccurring themes were people dressed in polos and khakis a la Donald Trump.
Yeah.
In fact, the guy who ran his car into that young lady was pictured the day before dressed in the Donald Trump garb.
Yeah.
Like, as a matter of fact, that's a kind of like a symbolic uniform of that movement.
We are, even though we're clean cut, keeping it, we're following the rules.
It's to inflect that.
Yeah.
That we're law and order. We're not this crazy fringe. They're actually like rebranding themselves into this nicer version of white.
What's crazy evilness. Is even though they do rebrand themselves, they still know they need the David Dukes, though. They need that Southern Confederate uneducated group of people to help empower them. That is also an element that gives them a little power, that gives them the violent element, I feel like, and I feel like that's what gives them like kind of their scary presence.
Well, it's like it's a populist movement, but it's a populist movement in the negative. Whereas in the Obama era, there was a populist movement, meaning that there were a bunch of different factions or coalitions of special interests that got behind one brand, the Obama brand, and ascended to the presidency.
Yeah.
Same thing here. But whereas Obama was going on positive hope, change, unrealistic goals, whatever.
Sure.
Trump is more hardline and digging into the more vile aspects of American culture, but aspects of the culture that have always been there.
Yeah.
I mean, Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump were racism by degree. Now, far in spectrum in terms of degree, but liberal racism very often has the same negative effects as conservative racism.
Yeah, you know, a lot of times the argument is like, the you'll see, I follow a lot of conservative people on Twitter because I like can't believe it. It's like I got to realize, you know, when people say there's multiple realities, I'm like, you don't have to look in the universe; it's right here. You know what I mean? And I always tune in when they have the black conservative on, because like, but the point they always drive home is
when
like,
they find this
stop thing. Supporting the liberals that say they're going to help black people and don't help black people. The conservatives are keeping it real; they're going to help you if you deserve help. And it's like,
if you, but that sounds, but like they ain't even going to help you.
Exactly. Yeah. But if that's kind of like, they're help, like, yeah, exactly.
They're shit on everybody.
But their whole point is like, we're not going to pretend like we're helping you. We're not going to wrap it up in this thing and then really be fucking you. You know what I mean? And they always try to like, you know what I mean? And like,
yeah. So it's either, that's why it's I'm like watching this fucking you or up front fucking you.
But either way, fuck you.
It's doggy style of missionary. That's all we got.
But then they like tie it, but it'll leave you an opportunity to do it on your own. You'll be able to pull yourself up by your boots, the whole thing.
I mean, and those are such overused phrases. Pull yourself up by your bootstrap. No society. Society, the concept of society in and of itself denotes cooperation amongst people who don't have any interest other than their own survival.
Yeah.
So conservatism is a fantasy in and of itself. When has society ever moved backwards or wanted to move backwards or better yet even stay where it was at?
Yeah, we're trying to progress.
And I was listening to some of the rhetoric. You guys see that Vice video?
Yeah, I want to talk about that as well.
The people on the ground, and I'm listening to like what they're chanting, like blood and soil. Those are very old phrases, but they denote white privilege in the fact that white people believe that this American soil is theirs, and everybody else is just borrowing it.
Yeah. What is the concept with like Christopher Columbus? Because it's not like he was British; he was from Spain.
Yes.
And they're like, but we don't fuck with Mexicans. So if you're just white enough and you like clam chowder, you're good. I don't understand. Like, you know what I mean? Like, as far as like earning the land and the,
earned the land, and it doesn't make sense.
It's like it's a weird way to pinpoint history. Like, we're starting it from here, and this is where we're serving our identity, and that is just so.
Because it fits into their narrative, because whiteness was a created thing. What they're saying is, we know it was a created thing. It's here, so fuck
yeah. What
y'all.
Do you say that blackness in America is also a created thing?
Yeah,
because it seems like not that black people choose this maybe all the time, but for some reason, and I feel like a lot of times when black people as a whole get into trouble is that we choose to also pinpoint our history starting from slavery. You know what I mean? Even though black history goes way farther than that. We didn't. We a lot of times growing up, I feel like people grow up like slaves, free, Jim Crow. Now we're here, but like as if black people weren't kings. You know what I mean?
People had access to that history like that.
Exactly, but it's weird how I don't know. I guess
like I had no idea until college.
Yeah, same.
People, I think a lot of times it's because on both sides, white and black, they're pointing to slavery because slavery is a point in history that created problems that reverberate. Almost
and
like
that's why we are not Africans. You know what I mean? That's specifically like what a big distinction. You know what I mean? And I feel like as far as history, it's like we learned we came from Africa and then it would just jump forward and be like, Africa's fucked up now. But you didn't know what was going on before, you know what I mean? As far as like what I actually learned.
Well, all human beings are technically African. Mm-hmm. Human life, we know, genetically started in Africa.
Yeah, that's the part I'm talking about. It's like, for a white nationalist, why wouldn't you take it even further? If we're going to pinpoint history and talk about heritage, what is wrong with going further? Do you not believe that as fact? Or
they don't. In fact, white nationalism has a counter narrative that says world history started in Europe.
There's a white nationalist, like a white supremacist scientist that came out. What was that nigga's name? He was like he was an anthropologist, but he was like, this is the most beautiful skull in all the land. Like it was the Caucasian skull. And then he kept like attributing like brown Asians, black people, Native Americans to like animals, monkeys. I forget the dude's name though.
But he was like being real subtle about it at first.
No, I mean, there was a lot in 19th century scientific racism. Yeah. It was when you during the 19th century, 1800s, when you start to see scientific categories coming up, or scientific disciplines like anthropology, psychology, sociology, they're trying to study the human body. Yeah. And that's where you start to get this biological racism, where black Africans are considered either a different category of species or a subcategory of humanity, meaning a deformation or a mutation.
Yeah.
And that's where you get this current language of white superiority, like black people being inferior. Those people.
Yeah, and even inside the black community, as far as even like literal skin tone.
Black people have, it's called internalized racism. Black people, in the way that we talk and deal with each other, have this idea of human value being associated with skin color and physical features.
Yeah.
And the lighter and closer to white your physical features
are. And that's not only in black culture. You know what I mean? And I'm tying this like randomly on Instagram. I saw someone reposted. I think it was at the VMAs one year. Some big performance. Andre 3000 wore like the white wig and all black. And it said, why do people of darker skin across all cultures end up being treated the worst? Or like statistically, blah, blah, blah. I was going to ask you that question. Like, why do you think that is?
The dude's name is Linnaeus, by the way. Yeah. Carl Linnaeus.
In Western culture, it goes back to that, what I'm saying, that the belief that skin color or physical feature difference means a difference in human value.
Yeah.
Meaning that because a people look a certain way, they are supposed to be treated better than another people. Nazis, for instance, a good example of a take black people out of it. Their whole ideology was based on the idea that they are a genetically superior race. Mm-hmm. Keep in mind, there was no German race at the time. He's creating a race, or better yet, the language is creating a race.
Can you describe that actually more in detail? What do you mean by that?
Meaning that the idea of race, race, we tend to think of it as innate.
Yeah.
But it's not. It's a concept that was made up in history. Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, America, what becomes the United States is who defines and refines the idea of race. And it takes years and years to do it.
Yeah.
The idea of humans fall into these categories doesn't come until the United States, when they get their independence, start thinking, well, difference is recognized, but where you start to get laws and rules associated with race. You don't get that until the United States moment. And even when it's happening right after the Revolutionary War, there are still and always had been free Africans in what becomes the United States.
Mm-hmm. They were just like, what did y'all do?
Who were courthouse? Those free blacks are the reason we're sitting here. because their rights were inextricably tied to slaves. Slave and black become collapsed over time. Don't believe me? Go look at the first census.
Yeah.
By the second census, slave and black, slave and colored, or colored and free kind of start falling into the same category.
Yeah.
By doing that, you're legally trapping free blacks into servitude, or better yet, second-class citizenship, and moreover, second-class humanity.
Yeah.
Fugitive Slave Act.
And it takes hundreds of years for us to dig out of that.
You know something I don't really get about American history? So, you know, we come over here, we're the fucking pilgrims, we're fucking all the Native Americans in the ass, we're pushing them out. At some point, the Chinese come in with the railroads. How does, and we're starting our independence and free blacks, and then the concept of slavery, and to actually tie race to skin, is there no Mexican around? Is there no, I mean, is there nobody yes. from other cultures that are getting affected? Like, how did, like, why were only black people slaves?
No, but, I mean, everybody's affected, though. As far as like Hispanic people, like we have to watch a documentary.
I just wonder about, you know what I mean.
There slavery exists all over the world, and even in the United States, it wasn't just black people who were slaves.
Okay.
However, over time, slave and black become synonymous, but that's after U.S. history, United States history starts.
Yeah, I know. After United States history starts.
Okay. Well, even in the colonies, well, during colonial times.
Yeah.
There were slaves and indentured servants of all races and classes.
Yeah.
Slaves were primarily African, but they were also, there were Native American slaves.
Okay.
There were white slaves.
Yeah. I had a thought that I didn't want to say because I was like, he's on some high level shit and I'm on some low level shit. How many slave movies do we have to go in the future, Ultimate Realities or whatever, until we get the slave movie where it's like the white slave. There was a white slave in like a black community, but like everyone accepted them. Like it's like a slave movie, but it's about the white slave.
Read Irish literature. I mean, this white guy at A&T put me onto it, but white slavery in Europe took a lot of forms. But like one of the major forms was the way the English treated the Irish.
Yeah,
both in England and over here.
Yeah,
They were the black people.
They were the niggas, bro. That's why they hate. That's why they were so angry at black people.
Yeah, I was about to say, wasn't the N-word didn't only refer to black people whenever, like, in its, like, you could call an Italian dude that, you could call, an Irish dude that.
Bro, like I was saying, bro, it had a documentary class where, like, Mexican families would hide that one black person that's in the tree because of fear of discrimination or persecution or just people talking shit about you around town. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Just, like, fucking, like, not saying, like political or government type shit, but like just like, yo, don't let nobody know about that blacks. Like they were seeing, like, I pretty much in a long story short, it's like we were all in the room. It was racist. They white people fucking black people up. Everybody saw that shit and said, yo, just don't. If anything, if you got any kind of black in you, don't talk about it.
Well, the concept of slavery as we received it is built on the backs of black people.
Yes,
and we see it, but that took time.
Yeah.
And part of the reason black people or Africans were designated as slaves were because of the physical difference, easily identifiable.
Yeah.
And they are so far away. They were so far away from their home.
Yeah, and they were brought here. A lot of these Irish people and these Italians, they came here.
You know what I mean? Irish and Italians can blend in.
Yeah. If they run away, bro, they're gone.
Indians. Native Americans can blend in.
They know the land also. They can get away.
Yeah.
Black people is sticking out.
You sticking out like a mother.
Now, there were a lot of... Like,
we ain't never seen a horse like that. Or like, you know what I mean? We ain't never seen...
There were a lot of runaway slaves that blended in with Native American cultures.
They were like, yo.
I mean, that is a part of the narrative.
Navajo,
You find some quadroons? Or
I still know black people say they're Cherokee.
They are. I mean, if you look at Native American photos, they lighten up over time.
Yeah.
Follow those pictures and map them out with a census.
You'll see a black person in the background like, hey, we're good, right?
At first, Indians don't, or Native American, the term Indian doesn't get put on the census because they haven't incorporated them into their world yet. But once they start incorporating Indians get lighter over time.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah. And dude, my grandma always said this. She's like, whenever a white person say they got some Indian in their family, it's because they don't want to talk about that fucking that slave pussy or whatever. They don't want to talk about how they dude, part black.
It's like my family is like, you have some Native American.
Well, that's something always, I've been talking about.
Like, why does everybody got Native American but nobody got black in them? I know I got white in me. Yeah.
Can you have white in you, but white people ain't got no black in them?
Bro, come on. Thomas Jefferson
fucking everybody.
Sally Hemings, Thomas Jefferson has kids by his wife and kids by Sally Hemings. No, two kids. Does that make them not brother and sister?
Two kids by the white wife, like six kids by not Sally Hemings. Six.
Hey, man.
Does that make you okay?
I've been there. We brothers. We kin. We look alike.
They got that DNA in them.
Yeah.
They don't want to talk about it, but. Think about how many black people.
In the history book, does it say he has two kids or some shit like that?
They don't talk about it, bro. Yeah. You got to dig.
They just started talking about that publicly.
It's not super under the surface, but like you got to like dig a little bit.
What if you can talk to Thomas Jefferson and like he's like around in the writing history book? He's like, man, not because she's black. I mean, who wants to? I mean, this is my side piece. This is not my main. I don't want, you know what I mean, it doesn't matter. Because even
bro, Woods was making these black girls so angry in class. He was like, man, is it possible for a slave to love their master? And these girls are just going like, no, no. He was like, we don't know. Woods be going, we have no idea.
Yeah.
And I'm like, Woods, you know what you're doing. But it's just like the way, it's like
he was tapping into something.
Thomas Jefferson was giving, like, it was weird. He was like giving some niggas freedom. Denouncing slavery, having hella slaves, like it was so weird what he was doing.
He was like, by the hour type thing.
Sally Hemings live adjacent to him, like it was like underneath him or like right beside him, something like that. Like,
well, okay, how can you say he loved her if he basically has her prisoner,
bruh?
I'm not saying you.
I am Thomas Jefferson.
He's a complex man.
It's complex. For America.
American history is complex. That's my new euphemism.
For America, I'd probably say complex. Like, go. For black people, I'm like, nah, I can't fuck with this nigga. For America as a whole unit, I'm like, all right, I guess.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Donald Trump literally was like, what are we going to do, take down Thomas Jefferson? And some people
I told you the problem is slavery.
Bad. That's not that bad.
I mean, Washington, Washington
yeah.
had slaves.
Yeah, but is it the having slaves, is that what it takes for us to be like, you're not no longer?
Well, once you get past slavery, then you got to get past all the other atrocities. Actually have to start doing what black people have been saying since the beginning. Deconstruct the whole
another issue.
We're gonna put Mark Zuckerberg another on some issue, money and then be like, he never heard.
Another issue was Sally Hemings was like 14 when they were doing that shit, and the girl was like, he's a pedophile. Frank was like, that wasn't a word until like the 19th century. So like. It's a lot of well, I mean, era variables. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
At that time, 14 was like birthing. I mean, she was middle-aged.
People living in 32.
Yeah.
But the girl's like, he's a pedophile. And I was like, that wasn't a word then. He was just a nigga living life.
Yeah.
As far as like, owning slaves, it's like, you have an iPhone. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it was as far as that era and that region.
Okay, I got to push back against that because motherfuckers say, oh, it was just the time.
I'm not saying
Okay. Although that is the law, you as a human being don't look at another human being and think, maybe that's kind of fucked up I did that.
But I mean, only because you've learned that, you know what I mean? I agree what you mean about at the time, and I just wonder, it's just so weird because you think of old times, you think about this puritanical, this like by the Bible type shit, but if you think about what's really going on, he's like, I'm doing it. I'm fucking
like, I think I don't know about everybody else.
Sure.
But I've been in my head for a while.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm saying, innately, I wouldn't want to go do no shit like that to somebody else. Like, I don't sit back like and have to fight back the urge to put somebody in bondage or some shit like that.
Be a good person, Armando.
Don't do that to me.
He'd be like, you ain't have no power, dog.
Like
you get to the power.
No. I think that there are certain human beings.
He's like, bro.
I think there are certain human beings who sit back all day and have to fight those urges.
Yeah.
Those are crazy people.
No, I think those are people that you talk to every day. If you sit there and send out a mass email and say, hey, we're going to have tiki torches and we can go be weird and kill people, they'll be there.
That's an email I would like to see. Was anything about how they organized?
Facebook chat Twitter, rooms. Twitter, I mean, yeah. Like, I mean, there was a lot of different organizations coming together.
Yeah, I
And a lot of different white nationalist ideologies coming together.
Yeah. Yeah, can you speak on that in a way that I'm not trying to paint you into a corner of what you would have responded, but the whole white nationalism thing, it's pretty complex.
Yeah.
It's not straight up like every single person has a hatred for people of color.
And it's a fear.
It is a weird thing, but it's like one of those like on paper arguments where it's like, I see your point, I understand what you're saying, but if you don't acknowledge the bullshit of what's going on here, then you have to be just as bad. You know what I mean?
It's a fear. It's a phobia.
Well, it's called xenophobia, the fear of otherness.
Yeah.
That probably isn't the right definition, but that's what it means. But anyways, at that rally, a lot of different ideologies came together, and some of those ideologies have conflicting ideologies. Yeah. Like I fucks with some of the people that they hate, and they hate some of the people I fuck with. For instance, you got redneck hillbillies hanging with neo-Nazis. Nazis who America fought against. Germans. Yeah, that's
the whole American,
like a whole foreign ideology.
Enemy of our enemy is our friend.
Fascism. They're taking that on. Many of them uncritically.
Yeah.
All under the banner of helping out a billionaire who is supposed to be a man of the people.
Do you think
ideologically, it doesn't make sense.
Do you think it's inspired or is it for? Because that's kind of what you made it say, like, we're doing this, like, this, we are carrying out his duty. Or is it like, we've been trying to put people on for a minute, and now we got to do pretty much green light in most of our shit. I guess before Charlottesville, they didn't know. We'll get to his response afterwards. I would definitely like to talk about that. But at the same time, I think they're just kind of like seizing the opportunity.
Oh, yeah.
And for whatever reason, he's not really thwarting them in a way. I don't know.
Well, that's what it's for. He's creating a culture where it's okay to do that. Well, it's called an anti-politically correct culture. There are people who sit back all day who want to go up and scream at Mexicans for whatever reason.
Sure.
The only thing that they think is keeping them in check is a PC culture that says you can't do that to people. Yeah. But under the Trump guise of Trump, that, and I'm not saying that they're doing it for him, like under his directive.
Sure.
But they're doing it under the idea that it's okay to do this.
Yeah.
In this social climate, and more so that it's necessary to do this. You don't travel across country to carry a tiki torch to a school that you don't go to as a grown ass man, middle of the week.
Mask off.
If they had played Future's Mask Off while they were marching, I would be like, goodness gracious, they bold.
I mean, unless in your mind as a man, it is an imperative. You must take action.
You're probably called.
This is their Black Lives Matter. White Lives Matter. This is what they're saying.
You probably called your dad for you left. Like, damn, I'm about to do your work, man.
I'm about to do the shit, yeah.
We talked about. Do you think if Mitt Romney had won, we have Donald Trump?
No.
Okay.
Because Donald Trump
like,
is.
Wait, what do you mean Mitt Romney won? Like, it beat Obama?
Yeah. In that second election, I don't think we had Trump because it's like, we already got a white man again. We good. We just need to get rid of all that blackness.
Donald Four Trump is more of a reaction to Barack Obama than he is a reaction to Hillary Clinton.
Lot of the problems, ironically so, and I've been thinking about this for a while, that these white nationalists have for this PC culture. And there's a gray line because me and JD, as comedians, as artists, we have a gripe of PC culture. We think censorship is wrong. We don't like people infringing on what we can say or when we can say or the words. I can agree with that sentiment. And I do see in ways where it's gone too crazy. Like, this is not freedom of speech anymore. You're actually not letting people speak, even though you disagree with it. It's like your fragile mind can't handle it. I do sympathize with that. I think I lost my original point, but it was about to be heat. These white supremacists, they're going into this like PC nature that's perpetuated a lot by like white people. Like, I see a lot of issues that happen. As far as just the gender, like the identity politics, it's like, I feel like that's like the crux of this. This is like what people are against or whatever. This is like the whole like liberalism has gotten out of hand type mentality thing.
Well, how is white nationalism not an identity politic?
Yeah, but I think their whole thing is to fight against that. Like, so they get all pissed off when
they're fighting so that they can be the only identity or the ruling identity. That's what white nationalism is.
Yeah, I guess that is ironic in its own way, yeah.
I mean, eat shit and die. This is America.
Yeah.
I mean, if everybody just puts themselves in place, yeah, based on what we say, if we're the law and order country and sure, the rule of law, everyone is a human being, and by the sheer fact that they're participating, they were born in this country as a citizen, they have a right to exist,
yeah,
and exert that existence,
yeah,
to the degree that it doesn't hurt anybody else. Why should everybody cower in fear of whiteness? Is any white person who was born the day you were born like worth more as a human being now that they're your same age than you are?
Yeah.
That's fucking preposterous.
Yeah.
But in generations before us, not way in the super duper past. I'm talking about, sure, your parents.
Yeah.
Like, your parents bucked that.
My mom specifically bucked that.
To this day, I mean, so it's not too far removed from your own experience. It is your experience.
Yeah.
At this moment, why should we go backwards and say, you know what? We are getting out of hand, y'all. I'm sorry. Okay. Hey, let the white people be the rulers. Especially since white people made the ridiculous ass decision to hire Donald Trump to be our president.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, he could have. I would hire Donald Trump for a lot of different things, but not for that job, because okay, what we said that job is.
I think what I was trying to say earlier is white people, quote unquote, elected Donald Trump, right? That is, quote unquote, I agree with that sentiment. But it's not all white people, because there's an exorbitant amount of white people on the left. I know you have this thing where you think these secretive white people were on the left the whole time, and they went in there and voted Donald Trump, and they didn't tell anybody. Yeah, I know you have that, but don't include them in this. So a huge group of white people voted for Donald Trump, obviously enough of them to make it happen. But there is a huge group of white people that were against Donald Trump that other group of white people hate, that I sometimes think they hate that group of white people more than they hate people of color.
I do too.
That's where it's weird. The white supremacy doesn't make sense, because I'm like, yo, y'all have a problem with a lot of white people.
They kill white people. Charlottesville became a national thing, or a part of our national history, because a white girl got killed. I mean, that is weird. That is weird.
It was strange.
They are,
everybody was like, whiteness
has been built on the back of white women. Being this precious
thing—that really, like, white, all the other white people know, like, we could come from.
Yeah, we will cut our own fucking throat. We will kill our own damn daughter.
We'll do it
to make this
that
white
is a
shit
line.
Keep going.
They're gonna burn our crops and rape our women.
That's some Game of Thrones shit. That's just
our women.
To be fair, he was driving to a crowd of people. I think he was trying to, like, murder a lot of people.
But most of those people were white.
Still white.
I mean,
very white community.
Very white school.
Whiteness is the thing it is. Imagine being to protect whiteness.
Can you imagine being a black freshman at UVA right now? You're like,
I'd be done.
3-4 weeks in. Would you not go?
I gotta leave. I'm like, I'm only tripping up here. UNCG, they on fucking college ad with torches. I'm like, yeah, I'm done. I want all my money back too.
Yeah, I feel like you got a case.
Look at this. I'll be on Snapchat. Like, look at my case. All my money back.
Yeah.
This is crazy.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be talking about nothing they're talking about. I want my money back.
If I was a senior, I'd be like, I want my money back.
Right now.
My degree's built on racism. I'm transferring.
Yeah. Look what you got. This is your school.
That's what I'm talking about. That's my ID.
I want my money back now.
Yeah.
I would just fight that hardest shit until I won. I'm gonna win.
Show up to the dean's office every day.
Nigga, look.
I'm not the person to talk to. I'm just the dean.
Your people's out there. Your people's out there.
Yeah,
they look like you. I'm not saying it was you.
I mean, and the people that, like, when they were the day after calling people out and like, so and so works here. Like, these were plain Jane white folk.
Yeah. I wonder how many black people at Home Depot just earlier that week had sold someone, like a white dude, some tiki torches, not thinking about it, and then Salton was like, fuck, did I, like, help?
You're like, shit.
Shit. I should have said something, but I didn't think. Well, I don't understand the we're holding fire sentiment. It's like electricity works.
It's a mob, bro. You make a torch.
Whenever you see, like, Frankenstein movies and stuff, when they're going to get the other, the monster.
I know, but it's so on the nose. I'm like, what the fuck, guys?
Send a statement. Going back.
But it's weird how, like, there's a way to protest, like, during the day, like stopping traffic or something, inconveniencing others. But it's like, night, you'll see us.
It was completely sanctioned. That was the thing. It was completely sanctioned.
There weren't a lot of girls, too.
There weren't
a lot though. That's another weird thing on just some man shit. It's like, because you know we're all supposed to be related and like we're all one, you know, one thing type shit. I'm like, guys, what the fuck is going on? Like, what is? If this is truly whiteness, why isn't there a more representation of the actual population?
Because whiteness is constructed around white males.
Or someone's got to watch the kids.
No, seriously. White male supremacy. It's called that.
Yeah, when you see the chicks, you're like, bitch, you think he thinks you're going to get all the rights he's got?
Well, I think we talked about it. There was a rejection of Hillary's womanness, her femininity.
Yeah.
As a model of, I guess, equality or leadership. Mm-hmm. It fucked with people.
Yeah.
In the larger scale of things, in retrospect, if I'm being honest and objective, the left did way too much. Yeah. We tried to combo them with the black man, then to the white woman. That was a lot.
Well, honestly,
we had a better shot. The Bernie Sanders.
I feel like always comes back to the DNC pushing out fucking Bernie Sanders.
Yeah, that was our but combo. Did, right but
there. But Bernie Sanders was too far left.
I agree.
He was old, and honestly, as racist as it is, well, it's a fucking America. He was Jewish. That you don't think. That had something to do with it. That would have been a hurdle.
Yeah, and you know, that was another thing about the Vice. Let's talk about the Vice guy. Hold on. Before we even get into that, when was the first thing you heard of Charlottesville? And tell me the level of surprise you were. And try to think in the moment, not hindsight 2020. Like, were you really like...
When I saw the torches, I was like, or like the news clips of the torches, I wasn't really tripping. I was like,
think it was going to be a thing? It was the next day that
that girl got killed, that's when I was like, oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. And then when I saw what was going on that Vice clip when they were on the ground and like these, I was tripping because these people really believe this. I believe everybody has a narrative in their mind of what this world is.
Yeah.
And I'm not those people really, they don't think they're wrong.
Multiple realities.
Moreover, they do it in certain cases. Not the guy who ran over the girl, but the marchers.
Yeah.
They had the law on their side.
Yeah, they did.
They had the permit.
That's where it's weird. Where it's like they should be able to speak. They should be able to congregate. I understand the argument if it's for hate and there's a line, but at the same I don't know.
I mean, I had to cover a Klan rally in Salisbury, North Carolina in 1998.
Yeah,
and it was on the courthouse steps.
Can I also say something about this? Growing up in North Carolina, for me, honestly, the Klan, even though I know it's real, I've never been afraid of them. I've literally seen a Klan rally. I think I was in Mount Airy. It was pitiful. There's not a lot of dudes out there. It was hot out. It seemed uncomfortable to do. It was just like a town spectacle, and most people didn't take it seriously. Like, there's even white people out there like, I can't believe this is so crazy. Yeah, they got to do it. It wasn't big, and it was just.
For me, it's not the organization. It's the mentality behind it.
Yeah.
The mentality manifests itself in multiple ways, and moreover, the mentality built the framework of this thing. That's what scares me. At any given time, people can tap into that matrix, and you never know who's masking that matrix. It comes out in or that ideology, and it comes out in people's behaviors, whether we like it or not. It's true. That's what the fact that people were comfortable in that mass to go out and do that. To me, that was what was shocking when I just started thinking about it.
Yeah.
Because like looking at those breakfast people, I mean, I ain't scared of this. I mean, fuck them honkies. Like, yeah. For me.
Sure.
Like, I whoop his ass. I whoop his ass.
Yeah.
Like that really wasn't what
it's
bothered
some weird
me.
Looking guys out there. Like a lot of stuff's going on beneath the surface. Like, I'm also insecure about my weight. I'm also, you know, my hairline ain't great. Also, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's a lot of stuff going on that built up to, like, I got to protect my fucking women.
Yeah.
I'm like, you're not fucking these women.
For real? Are we like, is it Game of Thrones? Like, protect from who?
My question
is. The only thing that's posing a threat is you guys sitting out here with fucking M16s.
My question is, what is your day-to-day like? Well, you're getting progressively angrier, and then you're like, I got to buy a plane ticket. I'm gonna meet up with this dude I met online, and we're gonna buy the same shit, and we're gonna.
Dude, they were dressed in military gear that matched what the police were.
Yeah,
Yeah. They had it looked like a fucking rugby scrum when they were just sitting there going back and forth.
I saw that meme.
Real quick. Black Lives Matter protest. It could be a mama, her daughters, a couple old people from the church, police out there, full military, riot squad, ready to go. These niggas had torches and machine guns and shields. Police out there with handcuffs, bro. Yeah.
They blew a dude up in Dallas for bringing a gun to that Black Lives Matter rally. They won't let those people damn near shoot. There was footage of people shooting.
Letting off rounds into the crowd. I was like, God damn. He immediately walked away. Like, real, like, shooter's mentality. It was real life.
And nobody's concerned about this.
The police out there in regular uniform with, like, pepper spray and shit like that.
Yeah, I'm concerned about this.
Yeah, everyone would like had that picture of like that black dude like protecting those white people, and I was just like, everyone's like celebrating it. And I was like this should be a
celebrating
statue.
Celebrating it.
Or this should be a statue because it was like he had to do his job, and his job was like conflicting, but he was doing his job because police officers are good. And I was just like, bro, you need to get the fuck out of there. You need to go somewhere else.
But the whole time he's in that picture, bro, they don't tell you like, yeah, shortly after somebody took this picture, he was like, fuck it, I quit. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, I got fucked up.
Just like, dude, to be in that position has to feel fucking terrible.
What? I always wonder what goes through people's minds. You know that when you know your job is to go do that.
The police were a weird element to it because they were like, they are lawfully here.
You know that black cops should have like, God, this shit is violent.
They're lawfully here.
There's way more people than us.
Automatic weapons
and shields.
I know, but that is the thing. So even though we're supposed to be here to protect them, just in general, there's way more people here than us at all. So as far as organizing and be able to do something, police are the minority. So if something breaks out, it's hard to have like a unified front to thwart whatever evil is because it's going to be chaos. So it's like they're kind of caught in a catch-22. I don't know.
I get that. It's weird.
You know what I mean? Because it's like someone could be swarmed. Your life could be taken. You see the dude with the gun. You're going after him. They think you're helping the left or their mind. And could you explain to me what Antifa is? And like the concept and like how
it's supposed to be a group against anti-fascism. However, I think I have questions about that group. I have not done a lot of research on that group. They just seem suspect to me. I never saw this.
It's like
this
who's inviting them to the cookout? Who is
this masked group? Did not pop up until Donald Trump won his election.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't,
and they, first of all, I noticed they get too good of camera footage. Almost. You know what I'm saying? Like, the camera's in the right place at the right time with the light.
Newest iPhone.
I don't know.
No Android. And my thing is, like, you never see them, like, you never see one taking the mask off or, like, being with people or people really, like, repping that shit, I feel like.
I think that is a red herring designed to say, ooh, look at the left being violent. I don't think there are too many people, although people support some of the issues Antifa says that they stand for. There are very few people I've never heard of anybody saying like, yeah, I'm repost this Antifa shit or I'm going to the Antifa rally.
Maybe this is how people on the conservative feel about this white supremacist. Be like, dude, I'm with the conservative shit. I don't want welfare. I'm with this evil shit, but I'm not with the real race evil shit. I'm just with the money shit. I'm not with
the money evil,
the conservatism. Like, but I'm like, I don't even know anybody that pulls up to this white. I don't know any of those dudes. It happens, but
I know a lot of old white money in the South though. Like, so I get the conservatism on their end.
Is there three conservative white guys being like, is this a red herring? That's not, I mean, obviously, I mean, there's a reality.
Yeah,
well,
I guess this shit is real, but I don't know. I don't delve off into the Antifa shit.
I don't know anybody that's like with the Antifa bullshit. I don't. And my thing is, if Antifa's so gung ho, do they not realize like, oh, we are fucking this up for everyone? We are.
I mean, the whole goal is people don't want shit to happen. Bottom line, the majority of human beings don't want no trouble from nobody.
And that was the weird thing.
Everybody just want to have their little shit. They want to eat and they want to chill. They don't want their prosperity to be fucking nobody else up, and they don't want anybody else's prosperity to be fucking their little shit up.
Yeah, that's the weird thing about the white supremacy too. And even in the Vice article and hearing the people talk about it, they're like, we are prepared for violence, but we don't want violence. Like, that's like this thing they keep pushing, even though they're very aggro and obviously they are very provoking and it seems like they are accepting of violence. It is a weird thing that they kept saying, and that the guy was, even though he's like, I got all these guns, he's like, there's not nothing I want to use. I don't want to do this, but this is all protect. But it's like, obviously he's fucking mentally insane.
I mean, very mentally insane. And that's and a lot of these people with guns are at least socially unstable.
Yeah.
If not mentally unstable. When I say socially unstable, they a lot of this narrative is built on this idea that they as citizens, they are under attack. And there are some bad neighborhoods in the United States.
Yeah.
But the majority of us are not hiding our purse, or where you got to walk around fully armed at all times because somebody is going to jump out with a knife and stab you or pull you into the alley and, you know, turn your son into an orphan. You know, that it's that false narrative is true for a lot of white people.
Yeah.
And the sad fact, it's white people who are the furthest removed from actual violent spaces.
Yeah.
People in the hood, I mean, there's a lot of guns in the hood, but there's a lot of there's a lot more people in the hood than there are guns, because most people don't got guns. Don't nobody want no trouble. Everybody wants peace.
Yeah.
Why is this small little framework being used to define our reality? When people do that, they arm themselves to the teeth and wind up going to spaces like to defend the so-called land against this supposed terror.
Yeah.
That doesn't fucking exist until you go make it exist. Charlottesville wasn't a thing until they did the thing.
You know what else sucked about this? My buddy came down to visit me like two Thanksgiving ago. He's from California. I pick him up from the airport. First thing, he's like, there's a lot of fucking trees here. Like, first thing he says. But then in the car, he's like my good buddy. I've known him. I would say one of my best friends. And he just candidly is like, we're in North Carolina. We're in the South. And he's like, so is someone, and he's like half Spanish, half white. And he was like, so is someone like going to like say some racist shit here? Like while we're here, like just ask me. I was like, what do you mean? He's like, are we going to go somewhere where like we shouldn't be? And I'm like, nah, I mean, there's nowhere. There's nowhere in North Carolina that we can't go. And then I was like, well, there really probably is places we can go, but we're not going to be any near any of that. There's no people that don't want us around.
We shouldn't be there. I ain't going there.
Probably there will be people that don't want us around, but we're not, it'll be fine. Like, don't even worry about it. And like, that's just his idea of like growing up of the South, like being a California kid, yada, yada.
Racist shit will happen.
It is also weird where it makes me think, it's like, is there white supremacy in Southern California or in Nevada or New Mexico?
There's white supremacy everywhere.
Well, I know that, but why it's weird and kind of shitty being from the South and I know why, but it sucks that it's also getting associated as like a Southern thing. Like, this is where it's really going down, even though it is everywhere.
Because the South is a rhetorical symbol of racism in America.
Yeah.
That's what you think of, like, in your mind when you say South.
Yeah. And it sucks, too, because, like, I don't know, growing up in the South, it's like,
the South is all right.
We experience racism, but there's a lot of great things about the South.
Yeah, Bojangles.
I mean, and everywhere you go in the United States, you can find some racism in there.
Sure. Very easily. People, yeah.
What's the time stamp?
We've been going for 47 minutes.
Okay. I'll just try to make sure we get some other shit in besides Charlottesville.
Okay, yeah.
No, we can keep going. I mean,
What's on your mind?
I mean, I want Armando here to break down the podcast. He's seen our journey and everything.
Okay,
like that.
Yeah. That's all right. This is a transition. Go.
It's a rough transition, nigga.
I know, but it felt right. The guy, I feel you.
I'm just saying, I'm like, Armando can go on about 3 days about it because Armando, he's passionate. You know what
and
I'm saying?
I'm also curious.
Bruh, he's like, you up there with D Noble and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like,
be dropping some names that only y'all two know.
Have you had D Noble on here yet?
Getting a hold of him is rough. And honestly, I don't think he likes me because he know I'm not like on the spectrum with him. Like, I'm.
What do you mean by spectrum?
He's who's very radical. In my opinion, he's radical. He got my brother all fired up one semester, and I was like, I mean, I'm real
D-Noble
neutral.
D-Noble is a dope scout.
He's amazing. He's amazing. But I'm real
how
neutral.
Radical are we talking? Like, with the Antifa shit? How radical are we talking?
I don't know. I'm not to put it, bro. Niggas was like, this nigga was about it, bro. Like, I don't know what to tell you, bro. Like, there's a protest niggas out there. Like, this nigga.
He was at the protest.
This nigga's doing everything he can to fight back. This nigga's doing everything he can to fight back.
Yeah, I went to the one in Durham. I was like, this is low-key a block party. To be honest, there's lots of music. It was like we were supposed to be there for the KKK rally. KKK never showed up. It was just black people, everybody hanging out, playing music, dancing. Wasn't no plates.
No plates?
A hot dog stand.
Oh,
nice.
It's kind of spur of the moment thing. It was on a Friday.
But I don't know. I mean, I don't. He got my brother. I ain't get riled up. I'm like a normal type Pokemon. Like, I'm very neutral. I'm trying to stay in my lane.
You think of yourself as a normal type Pokemon?
Like a good one though. Like I'm strong.
Like, I'm like. I feel like I'm half like dark, half fire.
Okay, something like that.
Or like psychic. I'm buffing my shit up. I'm like fucking.
Probably good. Dark and fairy, because like, you know, dark and light, whatever.
Is fairy one? I didn't know.
It's a new one. You ain't been keeping up, bro.
I haven't.
Yeah, but I stay in my lane. Zach got all fired up. Zach was like out there protesting. Zach was working out hella hard too. Like he was fucking like big as shit. He was big as shit and protesting. I was like, bro, you can't be out there like that.
Yeah,
because I'm like, bro, you'll be a t-shirt and then I'll fucking do something to myself. Like I can't. I'm trying to protect you. But he was like, nah, man, fuck it. And that's also that summer he went to the mountains. He was like protesting in the mountains. And like that. And I was like, I feel like you just beating niggas up out there. I don't feel like you're really doing anything academic.
Anyway. You got to have all lanes, dog. You got to have all lanes. You can't.
Bro, I saw that lane, and I was like, no, thank you. I remember I'll look at the lane and decide if I want to jump in or not.
Yeah.
And I was like, this is not my shit.
Yeah, you're this really is good not at, my shit. You're really good at looking at lanes.
I'm like, bro. Like,
judge your lanes.
I'm like, this. I'm like, my thing is, can I see me doing this in 6 months? That's my thing. Can I see myself protesting in 6 months?
So fucked up, dude. You know, why don't you try to do this shit? Maybe I'll just do this for a month and a half.
Because my thing is, like, I treat the police like the niggas on Assassin's Creed. I'm like, I don't want to get too close for that meter pop up. Niggas get hostile.
Did you do every mission like as stealthy as possible?
Bruh, I tried to kill nobody.
No,
I would knock niggas out.
I would leave bodies, dude.
Nah, bro, I was just trying.
You can't knock them out because they wake up. It's hard to get back out. I want to be done with the mission and get the fuck out. I got to leave some bodies.
Well, when I see a cop, bro, I'm just like, my head is locked up, and I'm just like, yo, just be non. Like, I can channel this, like, super non-threatening look. It's weird. But, like, I don't want to be out there with them niggas. You know what I'm saying? Like, my whole thing is, like, not drawing attention to myself. That's my whole shit. It's just fucking being like a ghost.
Yeah.
And, like, if I'm out there with, like, a bunch of other niggas, you know what I'm saying? And, like, I'm standing out because I'm a fucking 6'1" black dude or whatever. Maybe, I don't know. I'm just like, if I was a racist cop, I would try me. That's what I'm trying to say. If I was a racist cop, I would I would try me. Yeah. I look goofy. I look like you could take me down, make a point. Yeah. And like shut the whole shit. That just looks like
we got the big one.
We got the we got, and he's got that goofy whatever face.
Yeah.
So it's good for the TV. I'm like, no, man, no. Nah, I don't I'll fight back in other ways. I'm gonna fight back with hilarity.
Okay,
I'm gonna fight back. If I can bring black people and white people together, bring
you need to. We need to fight on multiple levels.
I'm fighting protest my way, bro.
in the streets being one.
Yeah, it's kind of like a nigga spending his whole life. Well, I'm spending my life trying to like get good at, I don't know, masonry. Niggas like, no, we need electricians. And I was like, bro, but I gotta build these houses, bro. Like, I gotta lay brick. That's what I gotta do.
Put down some tile.
Yeah, whatever.
Tend your own garden.
Yeah, whatever Mason.
Yeah, mow the lawn.
Niggas do.
Yeah.
But I'm just, you know, I don't.
Episode 100, break it down. What's up?
Yeah, episode 100, you guys started this journey to talk about getting better at comedy.
Yeah.
Stand-up comedy, open mics, the process, getting better. You wanted to bring together a community of comedians and maybe possibly connect a broader community outside of the Greensboro circle to talk about what the development of young stand-up is like.
Yeah.
I mean, and we're here at episode 100, so apparently you've done that to some
degree. Yeah, it's crazy. We kind of touched on the last one, but obviously
it's been crazy,
in the Lost Files. It has been crazy, and it... Did you, I mean, we talked about it last time, but we can talk about it again. Did you think we'd make 100 episodes?
I mean, like, for me, Micah kept bringing this shit up, and I was like, I mean, I kind of know this nigga.
Yeah.
And I'm like, bro, if you get the shit together, I'll do it. I'll be on it. You know what I'm saying? I'll co-host or whatever. I'll never take credit for the idea. I'm like, this is Micah's idea. I'm trying to, you know, find some other shit. But, like, I don't know, man. Niggas was so uncooperative at first, bro. I didn't know.
Yeah,
I was
people would ghost us.
Bro, people would just straight up ghost us, bro. Like, just on some...
And then you guys ever tried episodes?
We call
and
texting.
Yeah, we do the updates like about once or twice a month, or not more like once a month. We just catch up on what we've been doing and shit like that. Those are fun episodes too.
We started doing those because niggas were ghosts though.
Yeah, and then we kind of became kind of fun. I don't know. I like doing podcasts. To be honest, we're doing 100 of them. We really done like 104, but
And just sitting down talking, man, you just get better at fucking just like riffing and shit like that.
Yeah. Has the process made you guys better comedians?
I say 100% for me.
It's tied it so close together. It's not that I've ever thought about quitting, but it'd be hard to quit comedy because I'd be like, I don't want to quit the podcast. You know what I mean? Or like vice versa. You know what I mean? I don't know.
Like, I mean, I hear feedback about it. Like, you guys actually, like, comedians listen to you.
Wait, why'd you bring up quitting? He was like, did the process make you a better comedian? You're like, man, I can't quit.
No, well, I feel like it's, like, I was trying to relate that, like, as I've gotten better as a comedian, I feel like I've gotten better as a podcaster. And they've gone, like, so hand in hand. I guess, I kind of left it open-ended, but my point had come together, like, that made me a better comedian. It's like, I put them together. You know what I mean? Does that make sense?
Yeah,
fast. 7 months in, and true. So I just tied it together. That's okay. Funny. That's funny you said that, though.
I was like, where'd that come from? I was like, nigga, who's quitting?
Nah, but it's I don't know. Yes, I do think it's made me a better comedian. Just because it's made me so invested. I think that it's increased my investment. Because I started it being seven... This is a better answer. I started being 7 months in, and I talked about this last time, that I got to meet a lot of people in the community through this podcast. Like, my first real conversations are a cool 2-hour-long conversation about their life, and I really get to know them, and I am really interested. And it's like, now I've made these friends. I've made these connections. I've known their path. I've seen the similarities. You know, it has improved me as a comedian. I don't know if I'd be the comedian I am now without the podcast, to be honest.
I feel you on that. It's definitely like you get an extra stage time too, like fucking
for sure.
2-3 hours of stage time just fucking hanging out with your friend, you know, telling jokes and whatnot.
And like comics, no matter how long they've been doing it, that's the amazing thing about the podcast. People will drop knowledge at any moment.
Yeah.
We'll just drop some shit that'll, no matter where you are on the spectrum of being a comic, you understand what they're talking about. Yeah. This helps. You know what I mean?
Well, like, as comedians, don't you get better by getting to know how people's personalities work? Like, that's how you develop yourself.
I mean, you try. I mean, some people lose focus. They, like, start thinking about this shit, but that's part of it.
For sure.
You know, learn how to read a crowd sometimes, back out of a joke if you have to.
I think it's also, like...
Read a room. Read the nigga before you was doing some shit that ain't working. Like, yo, fuck all that.
But even the conversational element, I do, like... Sometimes when I'm, like... Like, I don't know if you... Whenever you go to crowd work or you're, like, kind of, like, riffing, I don't know if you're thinking about something, but what helps me with crowd work is, in my head, I'm telling myself, like, actually be interested. Don't try to immediately think about a joke. Like, because there's something about when I'm actually interested, the joke just happens and I'm not even thinking about it because I'm really just talking to them. And when I'm thinking about being interested, I'm thinking about what I think about on the podcast. Like, listen. When they say something, like, what did they just... You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But that goes back to what you were talking about, being invested.
Yeah.
Have not been doing that at all with my crowd work.
What do you think about when you're on crowd work?
I'm gonna let you talk for a little bit, and I'm gonna roast your ass. Like, that's like that's my whole thing. I'm like, I'm gonna let you talk for a little bit, then I'm gonna roast you, just because like this is still important to me.
Yeah.
I'm gonna let you get something out because I want people to hear your voice before I roast you.
Yeah. Well, I think, honestly, basically, the short form of what I'm saying, I'm just trying to wait to roast. I'm trying to get to know a little bit more so I have more to roast. Because, honestly, if I think about it, I'm listening to them, like, go at them. That is, you try to rip them apart. Not rip them apart, but try to, like,
I'm just like, bro, joke about it. I need you to know what's up right now. Like, this isn't no game. Like, I try to, like, tell.
Like, oh, you're a student. What do you study? You mean you?
Yeah, it's like, this, like, with the, this is, I want this to be my job. So when I show up, I'm like, okay. Go 110% because like if this is going to be worth money one day, I got to make it work now.
Yeah.
And when somebody's talking during my time, I'm like, bro, you have no idea how much this 4 minutes means to me.
But also there's something to working on crowd work.
I mean, working on crowd work. But I'm talking about more if I'm like trying to like, if I'm at a show or something like that and I'm trying to do a set. If it's like an open mic, fuck it. Let's go for it.
Fuck it.
Yeah. You want a screwdriver for that?
No, I think it's this thing.
Okay.
There we go. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Where's the podcast going?
To the top, I think is what we said. We'd take it to the
top. Yeah, tangibly Atlanta.
Yeah, okay, tangibly Atlanta. That is that'll be the next home of the podcast.
We means gonna keep doing it, man. If we can do it until somebody gets on TV, that would be. I'm like, yo, okay, I think we're done now, because you can't even, like, you can't be open mic if you're on TV.
No, I think
right.
I think we'll change and evolve, but we'll always.
You can't. You can't.
In my mind, it's at heart, we'll always be open micers. Like, because no, if you talk about being on TV, once we get to TV,
so we're, like, gonna, man, be y'all fucking frauds.
We're gonna be open miking being on TV, or like writing.
Yeah,
or,
I hear you on that.
I mean, like, it's.
But always I'm saying, be, I can, if for some reason Michael's like, yo, I got a contract in Russia, I can't do it no more. I'm like, all right, bro, I feel you.
In Russia, we could Skype, we could figure it out.
But I'm saying, if the contract was like, you can't have no contact with these niggas in America no more.
Why do you think people make contracts like that?
Niggas, contracts be on some real shit. Like, yo, don't talk about this contract.
Have you ever signed the contract?
I don't like it. I sound like for like apartments and shit like that.
Sure.
Do not like it. I don't like
it. Do they have any clause where it's like, don't fuck with these niggas?
I don't be reading like that.
They could. You might be fucking around. If they, dude, they could put in so many contracts just like on one line, on like the eighth, just don't fuck with any niggas. And people wouldn't even ever read it. No one would ever see that.
But why plan for that inevitability? Like, of all the random shit in the world that could happen.
True.
Why plan for that to happen?
Yeah.
What if the energy you give off to the universe is what defines what's actually going to happen? What if you say, man, yo, I'm going to go down to Atlanta and I'm going to get on a motherfucking TV show. Fuck it, I'm going to go down there and create a TV show. Why not start filming the podcast?
Yeah, that's another element.
Let's not film this shit.
Well, that's the thing we're actually trying to reason with. That's actually the thing we're trying to, like, kind of like, where do we sacrifice the true elements of the podcast? That, I mean, honestly, we just got to get it to that fuck it money. If we can get fucking money, then we can do it. We can go
to the internet.
But we don't have fucking money.
Dude,
but
once we get some fucking money, boy.
I'm being
real as fuck right now. If I get some fucking money, a lot of numbers getting deleted.
Are you going to delete my number?
No, nigga, what the fuck?
I don't, just the way you said that.
You at the table with me.
You're talking about the contracts and shit? I don't know.
I want a contract so bad.
Nah,
I need some money,
bad.
Bro. I just need some
contracts
fucking money.
Contracts lame. But it could be lit.
I would do a boat for like 8 months.
A boat?
Like a cruise ship?
Have you ever been like on deep sea, like a deep sea boat at all?
No.
Yeah, I would hate to be fucking sick. You know what happens to people? You're like, fuck it. Like, you can't do anything. You're literally seasick. You're like thrown up. You can't handle the equilibrium. I guess you take some Dramamine or whatever the fuck, but I remember my grandpa telling me he tried to go on like this church trip. Like, hey, we're church at the beach just because we raise money because of God or whatever. And they're all at the beach, and they're like, we're going to go deep-sea fishing. All the guys, the dads, they're all going to go deep-sea fishing. They're funding it, whatever. Got there. There's maybe 20 dudes on this big-ass boat. Four guys are torn. Like 12 of the guys are, like, they're throwing up, absolutely sick, completely ruined. It was fucking terrible. People throwing up that aren't sick because other people are throwing up.
I was about to say, I'd be throwing up. If I see somebody vomit, I'm done.
It was just, like, literal hell. And it was just like, well.
Were you on a boat, too?
No, he was just told me about it one time, and I was just like, damn. It's like one of those things as a kid, you just like sticks in your head.
I was thinking maybe my depression keeps me so woozy on land, mixed with the fucking the sea, I'll be stable.
Nah,
just doing hot ass sea jokes.
I haven't been in a science class in a while, and when I was, I wasn't paying attention. But I don't think from that standpoint that's scientifically correct.
I hope it is though. I'm thinking about money. I mean, I've been through hell. I know what's going on. I need the cash.
For a depressed guy, that was a very positive spin on that. You're like, oh, I might be sick forever. Well, maybe my depression will actually help me in this case, and I can still get that boat money.
I've been feeling way better, man.
Like your body, like took it. Like you were like boat money.
Yo, depressed tried to kick in the gym, and I'd be like, you ain't got no place here. A nigga making gains in this bitch. What are you doing? My depression's fat as fuck. You can't keep up with me.
That's what it is. Yeah, you gotta run away from it.
No, I'm about to be chilling. I'd be like, bro, what are you doing?
You need to do that joke again. That fucking applying for more jobs joke.
That shit wasn't funny.
I love that shit. I thought about that the other day.
What was the applying for jobs joke?
The whole joke was just like, when you're applying for jobs, you gotta be super nice. You gotta be like, oh, thank you, sir.
My mom. That's the part.
This is some real shit. I was on the phone with my mama, and I was like, Mom, I'm trying to find a job. I swear to God, I'm trying to find a job. I'm trying to get a job. I'm looking for places and everything like that. And then she was like, Josh, no matter what you do,
you're my son. I love you. Just don't ever give up. Just don't stop. Don't stop. Just don't give up. And I'm thinking, she's talking about comedy. I'm like, oh, mama, it's so sweet. He said, don't give up comedy. She's like, nah, I mean, don't give up on applying for more jobs.
Never give it. Don't, never don't stop.
Like, she's like, no, like, send me your resume. I'll look over it. we can fix some errors, but like, you gotta keep sending them out there.
Yeah. You gotta have a,
you gotta keep, and also do some callbacks.
Yeah.
Like, I was just like,
are you calling them back?
Back in the game.
But like, for a brief moment, I was like, she believed in the comedy thing. Cause like, she's seen some of my shows and yeah. Like, she's like, nah, you need a full-time job. You need health insurance. You need health insurance. You have, yeah. You know, your gums.
Yeah. Your gums.
401k. Yeah.
Yeah. Benefits,
but I mean, I tell it better, but it's like, that was the whole like thing. Like, my mama said, funny. Don't give up applying for more jobs, and I was like, I thought it was pretty funny at the time.
That's hilarious.
And then it goes into like how you got to be nice and talk about how you love to be a Mattress Firm or PetSmart or
yes, whatnot. I love pets. I've had pets. I love animals. Yeah,
I love animals. I will not fight dogs.
I go to the zoo.
I'll tell you
year.
That right now.
Yeah.
Actually, the zoo's like the worst place for animals. Like, zoos. If I become president, I'm shutting down zoos and strip clubs.
I can't. What's up with strip clubs?
I'm like, they that doesn't need to be going on. You been a strip club?
Once.
Yeah. I be watching documentaries. I ain't been in, but I'm like, I want to help. I'm shutting down strip clubs, and I'm putting an emphasis on art. Get these girls some pottery. Some canvases.
Who's going to buy these stripper pottery? Why maybe, can't you do both? That's what you should do. You should start funding art classes during the day.
Hear me out.
You should shut down
everything
the day shifts.
Everything men that's do in society happens. Is to get women. Like, that, like, they still talk about it all the time. Like, we don't like fast cars. Women like fast cars, so we get fast. Like, all that shit. If these girls, if all these bad bitches started painting, you don't believe some niggas would be like, I see what you're going for here. Like, niggas would, we would adapt. Yeah. Whatever the girls are doing, we would just adapt to, like, get pussy.
That is a funny point. Like, if you got, like, ladies, if you want to, like,
stop stripping and just paint.
If you want men to act different, you got to start acting different.
But on some real shit,
that's why it's funny.
And niggas are hating this shit right now, but the fact that a strip club exists and I can get $400 and just go in there and, like, really demean somebody if I wanted to. That's something in America that I don't agree with, honestly. I'm like, yo, shut these shits down.
Yeah, okay.
Let's open up some fucking art studios, some mental health clinics.
But there's the empowerment side for the females, like, that she can use her body to
and
make.
If they, no, this, they'll,
is that
I'll,
dumb? Is that
I'll
dumb?
Do, I'll do some kind of weird shit, like, you can have a strip club in Nevada or whatever. Like, that's where all the strip clubs are. If you really want to go for it. But I'm then like,
you
like,
have to do them in Atlanta.
But then, I'd be like,
Atlanta. It'd be a crime.
Okay, Atlanta. I'm like, okay, Atlanta.
They have the best strip clubs in the world.
Okay, Nevada.
So
Nevada.
I hear in rap songs.
Boom, right there. Nevada got the whorehouses. Atlanta got strip clubs.
I mean, but also prostitution's going on everywhere.
I ain't stopping anything. Let's be realistic, people.
Maybe 4, maybe 8.
But I'm like, zoos are sad. Like, those animals, that's slavery on, like, it's just like another. Bro, the Blackfish documentary will change your life. You watch that shit?
Of course. You ask me that constantly.
You seen that?
No.
White people care more about whales than they do black people.
That's gonna fuck you up.
White people care so much more about whales than they do black people. I'm watching an old white man cry talking about the injustice done to this pod of whales. He's like, you just see something in their eyes. And when you take one away, you can tell that they're, I'm like, he's crying. He's weeping. A grown man is weeping. Over these whales, and you be like, how you feel about slavery? All right, niggas, you know, niggas ain't shit, goddamn. Niggas be complaining. What the fuck you want?
It'd be funny, so funny, and be like, if someone's gonna be like, but like, whales are like black people, he'd be like, oh.
Bro, and this is how Armondo.
Yeah, that would like,
hit Armondo, this is how I know white people care more about whales than black people. This whale killed like 3 white women. And they kept transferring him from facility to facility to facility in hopes of rehabilitation. If a nigga hurt 1 white woman, death sentence. Double life. Yeah. Like, a nigga couldn't do none of what that whale did, bruh.
Yeah.
The whale was eating white women. The phone call was tragic. He was like, was there anything left? No, there was nothing left. I checked. It's just a blood. Like,
can we back up to the lot? This is why I say we got to start questioning. People need to start putting themselves in place. We got to start questioning white people just in, like, on a macro level.
Yeah.
How do you fucking rehabilitate a whale? what does a rehabilitated
please watch this documentary.
Well, they're like, we can't talk to him, but it just seems like he's cool most of the time.
No,
like,
but in the documentary, the nigga said...
He swims more than he bites.
The nigga said, when I first got there, everybody was like, don't fuck with that whale. Like, as soon as I got there, everybody was like, yo, that whale's cool. That whale's cool. Kind of ornery. Fuck with that one, though. With the curved fin, don't fuck with that
one.
You're
going to have to work with
that
it.
That one eats white women.
Yeah.
It's a fucking
shout
whale.
Out to that one white man that had his foot grabbed by the whale and then drug to the bottom of the tank for like a couple, like 30 minutes.
Yeah.
The nigga just calmly just white manning the shit out of the situation. See. Bruh.
Dude.
He just wanted to see. It's a whale. Like, it has no perception
whale.
Of
dude,
what the hell
I love. There's that
you
one
guys
point,
think is important.
There's one point at, was it Blackfish? What's it called?
Blackfish.
Yeah. There's one white girl talking about how another white girl had got eaten and she was like there. She was like, and we all knew the whale was like a piece of shit. And she was gonna fall off any moment. And then we saw her in there. We were like, oh shit, it looks like it's about to fuck her up. It started fucking her up. And we were like, but we kind of knew it could happen at any moment.
Dude,
and he
these
didn't
accounts,
get fed.
Dude, these accounts are crazy.
He wasn't
man.
Fed right earlier in the day. And she was kind of had an attitude when she got there. She
bro,
was on
well,
a period.
Also,
there's blood
dude,
in the water.
Also, I noticed something. When white people tell stories,
yeah.
They start off in the good part. Well, it was a Tuesday, regular day. They always start off in like the most routine shit. They were like, and then all of a sudden, and then they get to the massacre part. But I'm like, why are you giving us all this fluffy backstory?
Yeah, black people be like, I got fired.
A white dude be like, yeah, I woke up, I had oats, I had coffee, I got on the bus, and then, you know, I checked my email, I got to the office, and he's like, come in here, and I got fired. Like, what? What's all this?
Yeah.
But, dude, the accounts are just like, not like, yo, she got eaten. It's just like, it was, they always try to make the whale seem like it was chilling beforehand and something just happened. Like, the whale was like, before that, the whale was just like.
So there was like a flash photographer.
At the end, but like, over the course of the documentary, you can see like these white people turn against this whale. And they like start sending this shit. It sends this last facility in fucking Mexico.
Yeah.
Or whatever. Like, and they're like.
Eat the foreigners.
And the overview of the Mexican facility was like, spicy. Y'all, this place is not shit. These niggas is getting trained half as long.
Yeah.
The facility's half as big.
Yeah,
they got one dude that's good.
Yeah.
And he killed the main dude. Bruh. He killed the main dude, bro.
Give me the most powerful one.
He died recently. He just died recently. He was still doing shows up until he died. But this nigga just died off of some like trek of eating people, bro.
Yeah, yeah. Like going out happy.
That's part of white supremacy, the false belief that you have mastery over all the wild.
Shout out to white people for nature. For nature shows, you've never seen a black dude ever do a nature show. White people will always be out in the woods or the mountains or something fucking with
up.
Tarantula.
That's what's fucked up, white people. That's why we don't like you, because you know what? You think you can control everything. Like y'all control.
But you know, if we'll
be
around
like,
the animals,
like
we'll
not only
real.
I mean, like just like showing off, like we can control this.
Look at our zoo. Like
if
you
we
guys
if
are
we
in there.
Being real, I was like, yo, white people, I will give y'all ghosts and nature. Do that shit. Cause like I've never had the desire to like go in a cave and like fuck a tarantula. I can go on YouTube and niggas will be like, yeah, this is a guy, and just grab a nigga the size of his fucking arm.
Yeah.
I'm like, why do you?
It won't bite me, but it could.
Like, yeah. I'm like, why are you doing this? What in your heart?
I'm white.
Nigga,
it won't do it.
The thought of that on my arm.
Yeah. Yeah, literally in his mind, it's like, it knows that I have him.
If we're being
like, it's not in the wild. It knows I have it.
If we're being real, if I wait till about 2 o'clock in the morning, there's a spider outside my house the size of a wallet.
Like, that comes by and smokes a cig? What's he do?
I'm like, no, you should pay rent. Like, yeah. Look, this nigga, he's huge. He's huge.
He's like
not a tarantula, but he's on his way to be a tarantula. He's like working out. He got a dream and shit.
Yeah. He's like, bitches around here ain't never seen a tarantula. I'll just say I'm a tarantula.
God, nigga, huge.
It's fucking all the fucking spider bitches.
Let's stop talking about spiders, please.
Okay. You know what sucks about spiders?
Come on, bro.
You know what sucks about spiders? I don't think they get it. I don't think they get
their
spiders.
They don't get what they're fucking
they're like,
up
what?
Your shit.
I made my house. Look. I made my house and I live in it. Oh,
no,
creepy.
No. Some of the niggas know. The niggas that don't make whales, they just be fucking in your corner like this, just fucking like looking at shit. Oh my God. Those niggas know what's going on.
Nah, I think, but whenever you see one like crawling on the wall, like it's just like.
Did you know LA had like a tarantula problem?
No.
Or like California did? I was second guessing moving hard after that read that shit. Like you could find tarantula in your house, like you find like any kind of like water bug or.
Well, like if they're like desert animals, like scorpions and shit. Like I know in like Nevada, like New Mexico or whatever, like you could find a scorpion in your
garden. I would go back home. You know that, right? If we moved out there. Like the first week, I was like, it's a tarantula or a scorpion in the kitchen. I'm like, yeah, Mike, you got to pay this rent by yourself, my nigga. Cause I ain't dealing with that. I go to Atlanta. I'm like, yo, nigga, I was good in Atlanta with just a high AIDS rate. I'll deal with that
thing?
Shit.
Is that a thing?
Oh, really?
That's a super thing.
Yeah, you strap up everybody in Atlanta.
everybody strap up.
Yeah, but just AIDS and racism, I can deal with that. Not a fucking wolf demon spider.
Uh-uh. I feel like, nah, it's
no. I'm trying to tell you, but I told you about like who watched Lord of the Rings. I was like, if there's ever a moment where like you're relying on me to be still, but there's a bug on me. You're dead. Like whatever's about to happen, like, bro.
Just
you're
watch. If it seems like it's about to fuck you up, then move. But watch, make sure. Nigga,
nigga,
that's what I'm saying. It doesn't get it to.
Bro, I'm trying to tell you. Somebody's like, I'm gonna shoot you from Mike in the head if you move. When up. It's like I'm gonna shoot him in the fucking face if you move when I put this tarantula on you. Bro, you gotta say goodbye before that motherfucker touched my shoulder, bro. Cause I ain't know I'ma move, bro. As soon as I feel the weight, bro. As soon as I feel the weight,
I think you'll be good, but it's all there.
No. Should I tell you right now, nigga? When I feel the, them things is heavy, bro. It's a tarantula. Yeah, it's like a Rottweiler spider. I'm trying to tell you everything. I'm crying the whole time. Cause I love you. But I'm gonna move immediately.
It's like less than a pound for sure, but it's not like heavy.
I own a tarantula, bro. Them things is heavy, bro.
Did you touch it?
Yeah, I tried to one time. They make noise. You know they make noise?
Yeah, man, I figured it's an animal.
I ain't no spiders make noise. You know spiders make noise?
No.
Yeah, they make noise. They hiss. I was trying to change the water. I was like, nigga, move. Mm. He's like, just like a hard one of those. And I was like, that ain't.
You're ruined by yourself.
I'm like, I learned something that day. Like, just through trial and error. I was like, you make noise, nigga?
Did you give him the water? Or you're like, nah, you gotta fucking.
Nah, I changed the water. But I was like, nigga, I pushed him hard as fuck out of that. But like, yeah, I learned that day. I was like, that's not a regular spy. A regular spy has never hissed at me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's a tarantula thing. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can make a noise, nigga. Like,
yeah, like a bigger mouth.
God damn. All right, man.
Yeah.
But hope that never fucking happens. Though. Somebody puts me in that weird situation.
Yeah, me too, I guess. Fuck. I'm gonna try to dodge it.
Please. I'm gonna be winking at you and everything. Like, there's a way we can get out of this. Just don't stay still, bro. Like, I'm gonna move, man. I'm gonna try and fling it on with my shoulder. I'm gonna try and do something, but I'm like, bro, I'm gonna move, man, immediately.
I mean, I would try to stay still.
I'm bro.
What about your leg?
Nah.
What about your foot? You're sitting down.
Nigga, no. Bro, if it's, bro, on some real shit, once I see a tarantula, I'm on about a 9. So I'm on high alert. I worked at the fucking the Greensboro fucking.
Why did you have one there at your crib then?
I was trying to give up my fear of that shit. Yeah, that's didn't help. Right.
So you would walk in your room and be like, I'm a 9. Mm.
I walk in the room on a 9, bro. Out the gate.
Out the gate. Hey, did you ever go back and it wasn't there?
One time I came back, there was two of them in there, but he had molted.
And you were like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
What did it eat?
Crickets.
Dead or alive?
Alive.
Would they not try to run? And he was like,
they would try.
Did you ever have to, like, clean
it? But I had like a, yeah, it's disgusting. I had like a little thing from an aquarium, and he would somehow fit his whole body in there and like weave like a sticky web around the whole outside. So crickets are just chilling. They walk over there and get stuck. Nigga just destroys them.
Yeah, he doesn't like catch them. That's cool. Well, he just lays a trap.
He destroys them, just eating, just leaves a carcass in the fucking thing. It's fucking disgusting.
That's crazy.
You have to clean out the carcasses?
Yeah, I try to do it as little as possible. For being honest, man, I'm fucking high school. I'm frightened of this thing.
But like, put it in something, take it out.
My whole senior year was based around fear. I started working out because of fear. I started fucking, I bought that spider because of fear. Like, it was just like, I was doing a lot of shit because I was hella afraid, bro. Hella afraid.
I'm why?
Like, I was like, I had this big fear of just getting beat the fuck up in college for some reason. So I started working out heavy. And I wasn't like in shape, but I had biceps. I was like my thing. So I was like, if I get a nigga in a headlock, And like, if rat. I could choke a nigga out, bro, yeah. Like, you know what I'm saying? The same thing with like with the tarantula shit. I was like, nigga, I'm fucking afraid of spiders. And I thought that was embarrassing at the time. So I was like,
nah, it seemed pretty normal.
I'm still fucking. I'm afraid of spiders, but like,
it didn't really work.
It didn't work. But I was like, I'm gonna get this tarantula to try to fucking get over that shit. It died. I came back from a trip and it died. I mean, I liked it. It was cool, but I was like, I can never. It like it was a racist shit. I was like, you cool, but I can never like really be your homeboy
because I don't know because
of what you are. You know what I'm saying?
Like, it would bite you for real if you just had it on your hand. You just
it could, but I was like, I'm not taking the chance like that. I was going to pick it up one day, but once it hissed, I was like, you changed the whole relationship.
Yeah, it's over. But maybe he doesn't remember this. He was just moody. Can he not? He's not allowed to be moody.
I mean, I don't know what kind of thought press nigga has.
I know. It's like, but then now he never gets love again. He's like, but
dude,
fuck,
there's an insect room in the Greensboro Science Center, bro. Like, I had to clean that shit, and I'm like, bro, I'm in that room on like a 17.
What's the scale?
No, but I mean, they got just giant cockroaches.
But is there insects outside the area that they're like in?
What do you mean?
Like, just hanging out? Is there, like, ants walking around and shit? Is it just, like, do some of them get out and they're like, ah, just let them?
That's I said,
every room you walk into, you got to, like, lean in first and see what's up. But a tarantula could be anywhere, you know what I'm saying? So, like, I would just, honestly, God, run in that room, clean fast as shit, and then just run out. I was never, like, I'm never trying never to chance shit.
That. I would never do that.
But see, the thing is.
I quit. Or just ask me to do something else.
It was the worst shit in the world, bro.
Whichever's easier for
you. Why would you have an insect room? Yeah. And, bro, I see little white kids in there just tucked on the glass looking all close and shit. I'm just like, what? I'm just built different, I guess. I can't. Heavy fear.
More fear of spiders than scorpions? Or is it equal?
Spiders more, because I mean, I never seen a scorpion like that. I mean, I've seen niggas like on Discovery Channel.
I feel like they're like quick.
But scorpion, I mean, I ain't nothing motherfucker.
If you go to California,
shoot that shit, right?
The thing about a spider, though.
A scorpion?
You can really easily fuck up a spider. Like, as a human, you're like an absolute giant to it. No matter how big spider, even if it's a tarantula, you can salt the shit out.
They don't know how psychologically big they are to me, though. You know what I'm saying? Exactly. Like, psychologically, a spider's like an elephant. It might as well be an elephant. Because I'm like, oh, God, man. I don't want to talk about spiders.
All right, fuck it.
I'm afraid.
Traumatized.
I'm afraid. No, I mean, just, dude, man. It's like the worst insect. It's got to be, right? I mean, it all started like tarantulas, though, but like it's the worst.
Bees are shitty. I don't like bees.
Yeah. Aren't they all dying, though?
Maybe, man. I don't know. Why are you bringing up fucking death and shit?
Because global warming is an issue.
I don't know what's up. I'm going to be honest. I don't get the global warming thing.
I don't either, but that hurricane is real.
Yeah, the hurricane's real.
Scientists...
My science teacher freshman
year told me global warming wasn't real, and I was like, I guess that's all right.
I don't know. You know what's weird, though, when you look into it? It's like pinpointing the exact science, how much humans have contributed to global warming is like where it gets gray, but there is no doubt that we are contributing to it.
Oh, for sure.
That's not what I'm trying to dispute, but that is like the dodgy point of it. It's like there's no real way to tell. And I just don't know enough about science. I'm not saying, but it's like when people are like, it's definitely real. I'm like, did you try to look? Because I tried to look, and I might be too dumb. You might be smarter than me. But
what's going to happen when we run out of gas?
It's just, I don't know. That is crazy. Global warming is weird because.
Yo, swordplay is coming back. It's coming back. You're going to have a blade on you at some point.
We're going back. We're making life great again. We're going.
Was that really when it was great? Like, okay, if we're going to go backward, what point in history are we
Let's
going
not
back?
Stop. Let's just keep going back.
I mean, Let's we gotta pick it. Up time. You I mean, because this is bullshit. Like,
I'm trying to think of any time period. I was like, that would be dope.
Why that time? Well, I guess if
the
take sword the guns
shit
away
is coming
from,
back. I do believe sword shit is coming back.
Why?
We're running out of gas, man. Fucking everything's crumbling.
Gas is high as shit right now.
Nigga, they said hurricane niggas
shit,
went.
You
yo,
remember when gas was like $4?
What station got shut down because of it. Like, that's actually why.
It was like 2:15, and then the hurricane announcement thing, and then straight up like 2:55, 2:65, someplace like 2:85. I was like, man, y'all are some. Like, bro, that's that money evil we're talking
that's
about.
That's
like,
actually why
like,
I called
you. Gotta,
you
like,
What's up? I was going to ask, what was the gas like around here? Because I didn't know if I should get gas where I was.
Hey, get Gas Buddy, man. Just got the cheapest gas in the area.
Gas Buddy?
Yeah, it's an app.
Okay.
Yeah. I was like, man, how are you that evil? You're like, man, people are going to be running for their lives. So let's raise the price of gas like 45 cents.
Yeah, price gouging. People were doing that during
somebody
the
made that decision like overnight though. Like that's some evil shit. There was no thought process. It was like, hurricane, what? Oh yeah, 40 cent raise. That's a classic move. Classic.
Supposedly over that time, the cost of manufacturing and distributing that product jumped.
Nigga.
In that short span of time.
It
changed into something different. But at least it's not up to $4 or $5 like it was during Obama.
Yeah, but
and for hurricanes too.
Yeah, hurricanes seem so terrible. And I hate how there's always the dude's going around on Twitter now. There's always a black dude that's like, we ain't leaving.
You seen that dude on World Star? Man, I heard about the evacuation.
Evacuation, yeah. That's what I'm talking about.
The evacuation.
I'm fighting so hard to be like a voice of black people in my own way, and then like,
watching
I gotta,
Evolution.
And then I gotta go. I gotta go because of Evacuation. He's got more hits than I ever got in my entire life. Yeah, I heard about motherfucking Evacuation.
He could honestly, he couldn't tour for long, but he could probably do a couple comedy gigs. If he really took Evacuation,
if he made an Evacuation
dance and song, dude, that would be key. Someone's gotta be in his ear telling him this right now, like, dude, rap, just get a beat from somebody.
I mean,
he's no more crazy than the people out there filming him.
Yo, how much tied are you
with the benefit
paid?
From Florida?
How much are you getting paid to be the fucking goofy white guy reporter in the
Not
middle
enough.
Of the hurricane?
They never send a black dude. You never see a black dude out there in the wind.
I ain't going
never,
to work there because
they're like, I'm not. I'm sick.
No, it was an Al Roker.
I'm sick.
Let me send an Al sometimes.
Al's making too much money to send that out there. That you know, I don't know. He's got like I feel he's got clout wherever he works.
Maybe.
I respect the
possibly,
man.
But Al Roker will go out in a hurricane.
He'll go out. He'll fall down, too.
Now?
To a degree.
New body no. Al Roker?
Oh, no.
He's fucking recipes, dog. He's making food in the morning. He's barely talking about the news. I'm telling you, that's Al Roker life fulfilling.
It's some people that are famous, and you're like, I just accept
damn, what
it.
Is
like,
Al Roker
I don't even
doing?
Go into the history of it.
I fuck with Al Roker. I'm going to be honest.
How do you get? I don't know how he became Al Roker. I'm
he
like, what happened?
He started as a weatherman.
Just morning, just news. Just
yeah,
like
just
being
morning
out,
news,
yeah, so. Morning news.
Just being pleasant.
Taking it to the top.
Pleasant black guy.
Hey. Never having an opinion, but. Hey, you watching the NFL?
No.
I figured you would say that. I watched the Panthers game earlier. We did win, but.
I'm not even paying attention to the NFL. I mean, that's a simple one. That's an easy one.
Marcus like, fuck it, I gotta watch the season.
That, no, there's just so many things to that too. I just don't understand why the whole thing's that big of a deal. That's why it's like at the core. Like, I don't get why anyone would be so upset about him doing that.
Every now and then, I think
like it's so
you
crazy.
Just need
to
these
me.
Little consumer protests, I guess.
I understand that.
And moreover, the issues that him not getting a job represents.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it is getting ridiculous. There has definitely been a level to it, but at the same time, like, I see, like, the sport element of it, like, being an agent, being a team, being, like, at the end of the day, it doesn't care how I feel about black people. I'm getting paid to work at this job for this football program, and I'm not bringing any level of anything to bring anything to this organization that's going to distract us from winning a goddamn championship.
But he hasn't. What has he done?
Well, it's just he does have this like media thing about him. It will be a to do whether or not he'll stand, whether or not he'll do it. It'll be the talk of the team when he's probably going to go to the team and not start.
But people are doing it anyway.
Yeah, that is the interesting thing.
And
that's
people
unfolded.
Were doing it before.
That's the interesting part, like, that's unfolded. That's why it is strange.
It's only because the spotlight has came at him at this angle.
Exactly.
That this is a thing.
And I completely agree with you. So there is a reason that they're okay with it for the other players, because for whatever reason, Colin Kaepernick has become the actual face of it. So I think in a lot of people's mind, it becomes more about
money in sports before it ever becomes about race. But it is un-
But NFL teams love controversy, positive or negative, as long as cameras are in people's faces, that's getting people into the
I don't know, man. The they really skirted the you know, the dude that went to Notre Dame, they got
He
catfish.
Didn't do anything violent though. This is what I'm saying. There was never really any there was controversy about the issues that he's taking a stand for, but he never did anything. He didn't get up and say, you know, F the flag, or he sat down.
But at the end of the day,
and then off camera, behaved like a gentleman the whole way through.
My thing is, dude, when it comes to the sports shit, I don't think they really give a fuck about race, or they don't really give a fuck about a lot, because we've been putting up with the NFL,
they do, man.
Supporting rapists and supporting woman beaters. They have turned the other cheek and done little sentences, and I still allow these players to still play. Like they've put up with a lot of shit. You know what I mean? And I don't know.
Oh, well, I agree with you. With
you see what I'm saying? Like, this is not an organization that I've held to a caliber. They're like, look, but you hit your wife, but are you about to come win a Super Bowl?
They know they don't want any. They know they don't want their issue. They don't want any of their players identifying with race issues.
That's true.
Especially Black Lives Matter.
That is true.
However, it's been framed, because black people talking about blackness in a political fashion, or better yet, what they call a militant fashion.
Yeah.
Which just means people are being aware of what's going on.
Yeah.
Or called woke.
Yeah, yeah.
When black people talk about how modern day problems are associated with current and past history, white people get nervous, and they think that that is going to cut into ratings.
They got but threatened it when Beyonce did that halftime show.
Yeah.
But it didn't.
Was that like just people an internet watched thing?
It. So you can't say that they don't see race. You're right. They're willing to excuse a ton of negative or bad behavior.
Because they're just about the money in the
because
sports.
Because they're just about the money in the sport. But there's a certain line that they don't cross.
I'm just, you know what I think
and
it was?
And it's constructed around race.
I think if someone truly believed they could flip Colin Kaepernick to putting butts in the seats and getting people to actually pay to watch the games and buy jerseys, if they think they could really flip it and it would be
they
worth
have.
The money, I think they would do
they
it.
They have. Colin Kaepernick's jerseys weren't hot.
Oh yeah, I think there was a thing that like
people
a lot of
weren't
people
going
were
just to see
shit.
People.
But see,
people
buying
were
it
going to see him fail, just as much as they were going to see him win.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
During the losing season, they were selling tickets.
Yeah.
But the thing is, he's talking about this black thing. You can't skirt it. You can't skirt around.
I just think guy. I think if you ask the people in the NFL, they think
they're gonna
they
say
think
no.
Hitting a woman is worse than talking about black people's injustice of black people. So at the end of the day, they're like, it doesn't have to do with how bad it is. It has to do with they're gonna make their money where they can make their money. So even if they're selling the jersey and it's hot because there's all this controversy, they'll sell the jersey. But now if he's out and he's blackballed and doesn't serve anything and it'll just bring too much attention, I don't know.
They don't want him to be
I don't even know enough to even what I'm talking about to have this strong opinion. But
they don't want him to be a symbol of racial pride.
Not but other people are a symbol of racial pride.
They are implicitly, not explicitly. Not standing up and talking.
And that's the
not
part
Jim
that
Brown.
Suck. That's the worst
they're not
part.
Muhammad Ali. They're not Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. They're not standing up and being like, yeah, no, really, this is what it is.
That is a thing. But it's also a catch-22 because it sucks. Even like in the NBA, you have people that stand up, like the Clippers. They took their jerseys off. But there's a level they're like, I'm still going to play.
Yeah,
well, because they're still at work. That's like that. Yeah. Like this is how I get my paper. Like I'm not. I do care about these people and I do support this. But at the same time, I'm not trying to jeopardize the livelihood of my family. You know what I mean? Or
and they shouldn't.
And
they, and
but,
as a
but
matter of fact,
scared,
them
and
doing
that's what the
it
problem is.
Shouldn't do that.
Exactly. That is the problem.
That's why they're doing it.
I agree with that for sure.
They're saying that us making this statement, it sends a positive image to a demographic that is important to this whole franchise.
Yeah.
Let us do it.
Yeah. You know what is also funny about this? It's like the narrative that like as if.
It's not like when they took off those shirts, black people started rioting in the streets and burning white people's houses.
Yeah. And it's like the NFL, I mean, like sports, all this shit, they need black people on every end. As fans, they need black people. As players, as coaches. You know what I mean? Like black people are definitely a part of this. There's no way you could be like, y'all got to be quiet and not.
Is what I've been. It was well, to the point I was making when we first started this, black people have been here since this thing started, man. Stop acting like we're, you know, visitors, or we, you know what I'm saying, we're the stray cousin. Yeah. Fuck that. Thomas Jefferson had two sets of kids.
Yeah.
Fuck that shit.
Thomas Jefferson, man.
From the root of this shit, black people have been here. And we've been... You can't make a biological difference between us. That's what that whole, this whole 21, whatever those 23 chromosomes, whatever that thing is.
Yeah.
That's what all of that's framed on. And that's all you're going to see is, oh, well, everybody, there is no such thing as a pure anything around
here. Thomas Jefferson knew what's up. He was like, I know what I'm doing. Yeah. It wasn't like no fucking like one off, like this, like the myth of his one brown kid. It's like, I have this woman that lives in this basement underneath me.
Yeah.
And then I have my public going out wife.
Well, you should hear the way he constructs black people in his one book, Notes on Virginia.
Yeah.
He basically constructs black people as physically beautiful, or holding the capacity for physical beauty and the capacity for mimicry of humanity. However, blacks had no depth of feeling or innate conscious or cultural impulses, like we didn't create on our own. Mm-hmm. The best we could do is imitate white people.
Yeah.
Like there was no real ability to think on our own.
Yeah.
Or act on our own. In fact, it was fortunate for us that white people came along and were there to guide us. We finally, you know, were able to get this thing that they already had, which was culture, which was actually mimicry of Moorish culture, which was African culture. Like I said, it was that whole cycle of life thing. But right now, when you see those people in Charlottesville, or like when we just see us in our everyday lives, we're operating off of this logic that it's normal for white people to be at the head of the table.
Yeah.
Nah. Let's make this table a circle at the very least.
Yeah.
No head at this. Because if there is a head, it ain't y'all crazy motherfuckers.
Yeah, for real. The wildest part about Charlottesville is literally the next day, the next like 2-3 days, like Donald Trump could not have in more ways let the American people down. Like it would have been so easy, just the first thing to say is that, just to completely denounce white nationalism, you know what I mean, and the white supremacists that were there. It would have been so easy to do that, you know what I mean.
I'd have rather him make white supremacy go away. I mean, not that he has the power to do so, I'm just saying, I agree with public protests, like ripping down the statue in Durham in front of the courthouse.
Did you really, were you with that? It seems strange to me. Had you ever seen the actual statue?
Never seen the statue.
Well, one, to be honest, I moved to Durham a couple months ago, so I live in Durham now. I had no idea there was a statue there. Mm-hmm. It's not in a spot in town where people go. It's not like the statue, honestly. Like, when it really happened, I was right by when it had went down. I saw it on Twitter, like, right when it was going down. And I was just like, someone, I knew immediately, I was like, someone had to Google, is there a Confederate statue in Durham, to find that statue. That's not a big statue in the area. And if you go to the statue, it's not like Robert E. Lee. It just says, in commemoration of the men that wore the gray. So it's just as a commemoration to the people, just the idea that people fought here in this war. It's not glorifying a specific person or the cause. It's just... This is where this went. And it's a pretty small stat.
Also, some niggas had to fight. Like, that's just like, some niggas was like, God damn it. And they just had to go out there.
Exactly. I mean, this, you know, is a war. That is some like, nigga. I support, that, just, you know what I mean?
He was probably also racist as well. And, but I'm saying, like, and not everybody was like ready to go.
But it's not like, it's not a unified person that we know specifically had slaves. Yeah. That it is just the idea that this is the land, this was the community.
But at the same time, here. That's why it's a good target, man. Like, go for this shit nobody really know about.
It was
like
just
that.
So
fuck it
vague.
Up real quick.
So, it,
lightning
so
strike,
vague.
Baby.
It was put there to be a symbol, and it was taken down to be a symbolic gesture. Me personally, I mean, we would all have loved for them to take down the racism that was going on inside the building or whatever, sure, inside the government, but that's not going to happen. Yeah. So they're making this statement in the heat of the moment where it is done in direct response to a larger cultural event that it was in response to a backlash to Charlotte, like the whole cultural moment.
Sure.
Stuff like that happens in history.
Yeah, but that's when it's just strange. I guess it is the symbolic thing of it, but it's like, guys, these statues aren't doing anything to us. There are real things that are happening. You know what I mean?
Yes, I'm with you on that. Let's get at the real thing, and then the statue doesn't mean anything.
Yeah, I mean, I just don't. I've never cared about a statue. And I'm telling you, no one in the community knew the statue was there. I mean, maybe I've only been in Durham for a while, but it's not like I've been downtown all the time. I've never even go on that like side of that road. It's just by the courthouse.
White supremacy still rules Durham. I mean, that's just what it is. For sure.
Yeah.
Like statue or no statue.
I feel very confident there's people that we consider themselves white supremacists that live in Durham that were like, what statue are they taking down?
I mean, I'm glad that people are
I guarantee it. It's not like
let's go counter protest. I can't get off work that quick.
They didn't even show up. Like whenever there was like they had the
there
the,
wasn't even police there. That's the thing I was wondering, like, where's the police?
The police.
It's downtown. Wasn't it downtown?
Dude, I see that meme where it's the Spider-Man pointing at Spider-Man. It's like when the police show up to the KKK rally and there's two Spider-Men looking at each other.
Bro, the Greensboro Massacre, you hear about that shit?
No.
You heard about that shit, right, Armondo?
Yeah, the Greensboro Massacre where the police backed off. And yeah. The KKK came from all points.
It was a protest.
Yeah.
It was a protest. KKK showed up. It was killed everybody.
Yeah, it was the communist workers and black people.
Mm-hmm.
In a people's movement, meaning it was a coalition of two different factions, doing a march. I think they were doing a march in Greensboro on it was jobs or labor or something like that, or housing. And the KKK came with guns,
AK-47s and shit, like fucking,
and were shooting them in the streets.
Yeah, damn, it's footage.
Now you know, whenever black people protest, there's always police. Mm-hmm. The police backed away and let the KKK come in.
The police weren't there. They showed up like 15 minutes later. The police were the KKK. I had to do a project on it, and like a lot of the responders were, you know, KKK members. So like everything just got held off like 15 minutes. You know what I'm saying? The police show up just like, oh, damn, what happened?
Yeah.
Oh,
they did
what? God damn, why was y'all out here?
Yeah, why was your hair all messed up? Why are you so sweaty?
It's terrible. They was like, why was y'all, that was crazy. What they did, what? Yeah. Wow. That was the whole thing.
But that's, that goes back to the point. White supremacy is so ingrained in American society.
It's so subtle, my nigga. It's my thing, like, everywhere. Asheville, it's I feel it,
you see neo-Nazis, that's like a boil that shows up on the surface of the skin. But you have to think, like, that boil is connected to a whole living organism.
You know what's crazy about the Vice thing? While it was exposing a lot of sides of this, but that dude that they followed specifically, I was like, honestly, he obviously is a representation of this white supremacy and this white nationalism for sure. But I wish there was a better representation, a more person that seems sane, because that dude is absolutely insane. So when he's being so crazy with the guns, I can understand someone being like, I'm a part of this movement, but denounce him because he is insane. And just give me their still insane, sane, like what they're really thinking, someone I can relate to that. You know what I mean? That dude, I'm like, you're off your fucking rocker. When he was like, Donald Trump's okay, but he's not good enough because he fucking let his daughter marry off to that fucking Jew. I want like a more... better Donald Trump. When he said that, I was like, whoa.
Damn.
That's
what I've been talking about.
The racism. Jones out here?
I told you the ideologies are clashing. That's an example of it.
What do you think about Alex Jones?
Who's Alex Jones?
The white dude that's fucking
crazy right wing conservative conspiracy.
fuck him. I don't know.
Yeah, okay. I thought you he's always saying like the fluoride in the water's turning the frogs gay and shit. He's like
talking about the sixth dimension and how the elites are gonna leave us behind.
Fucking interdimensional vampires that are pedophiles fucking all of our kids and stealing. He says shit. He'll open a conversation and be like, child kidnapping per capita happens most in D.C. Why do you think that? That's where the White House is.
We have messages.
We have messages.
Tapes from Obama.
I have the
files. The Obama administration.
Pizzagate was real. People say it was real.
He started crying.
Yeah.
He'll start crying.
You're like, these goddamn motherfuckers. Excuse me. I'm sorry. Praise Jesus. Amen. Sorry, just these. Tear me down, but they're evil.
Oh my God.
The globalists
are taking. The globalist agenda.
The globalist agenda.
Will leave us all in ruin.
Yeah, I can't believe you never heard of Alex Jones. He's crazy. But
fucking hilarious.
People take him really seriously, and I think he, I don't know, he's more theater. That's all I was just.
Very, very.
Who's more scary, him or the people who follow him?
The people that follow him. He's like the insane clown posse for sure.
But he's like chill. I'm like, bro, I know for a fact. Yo, Alex Jones I know for a fact I could sit down and smoke with him. I know I could.
Yeah.
I know I could.
Yeah, Alex Jones is the ICP of like news media. Like insane clown posse where it's like, it's just this crazy weird ass band that's wild. Everybody got a crazy
friend, bro.
But their fans are are super duper crazy.
You don't know nobody crazy? Everybody got nobody, a little bit crazy. Exactly. Yeah. And then they'll like Phil, he'll play some weird shit and he'll be like, oh, it's Call of Duty? Like he'll pop back in and just be like my nigga for a second.
Yeah.
But I can't deal with the followers because everybody interprets shit the weird way. I know I can hang out with Patrice, but a Patrice follower, like them dudes that was heavy on Inside back in the day, like the dudes were calling and shit like that.
Sure.
You listen to the Black Phillip show?
I've listened to two episodes.
He crafted like it was some kind of war between men and women. It was funny as shit. And niggas would call in like, man, women need to know. Like those brothers would call in.
Yeah.
Patrice is like, this nigga's kind of crazy. But like, I can't hang out with those niggas. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, bro, you interpreting shit way too hard. Because there's always somebody who's like, yeah, man, he's good, but he's a little too soft on these areas. I'm like, it's too soft. Like, what are you trying to get to?
Yeah, what does it mean?
Just supreme, absolute
hardness.
Power.
Yeah. Yeah, episode 100. We out here.
We out here, man.
Thanks, you guys, for listening to every episode that you've ever listened to. We're not wrapping it up, but I just thought
I'd chime in with what we got right now.
We're at an hour and 45 minutes. What else do you want people to know on episode 100?
I don't know, man. Just working hard, trying to save money and move. That's the main thing.
Yeah.
When are you guys talking about moving, or is it just like some
saving money?
I want to have some real plans a year from now. Like I want to be able to set a date.
Like, is there like steps that go with the goal? I mean, I know moving to Atlanta is a thing, but what happens in Atlanta? It's a bigger market.
Bigger market. My whole goal to go to Atlanta is kind of like a life thing. I've gone and visited a couple of times. I really like it. It seems fun. I got a homie that lives down there. There's a lot of teaching opportunities for me there as far as music wise. And as far as comedy, the comedy scene down there, dope. I was like, went to a bunch of mics and like kind of like was in the community for 2 weeks, and it was really awesome. And a lot of movies and a lot of like management companies are in Atlanta. A lot of things get shot in Atlanta. So there's a lot of like agencies and stuff that have people down there that, and it's kind of it's a big scene, but it's a smaller scene compared to like New York or LA. Yeah. I would like to go to Atlanta, do comedy, get some experiences, meet people that when I go to New York and LA, I can leapfrog some stuff.
Yeah.
I don't have to go and start at the very bottom. You know what I mean? Like I want to be able to go and be like, hey, I know you, but this person knows me. Like, I want to, you know what I mean?
So
get some experiences, but maybe get some clout too.
So you want to be in different media.
Yeah, for sure.
Beyond stand-up comedy.
Yeah.
Stand-up comedy.
I would like to take this podcast to whatever level we could.
I'm going to be on Def Comedy Jam.
Are you, okay, this is just his
plan. Are you guys all...
we're going to the same spot, but I'm like Micah, I see that TV. I see it. I'm going to get on Def Comedy Jam.
I feel like you
that is straight up. If I move to Atlanta, I'm like, that is straight up. Going to happen at some point. At some point, it's going to happen. That's my number one. The whole time, I was like, yeah, Def Comedy Jam, though. And I was like, I'm doing that shit. That's bro, I've been watching that shit since I was a kid, bro.
Yeah.
that's my fucking dream.
support that dream.
Yeah. And then also get like stable future work and hopefully quit day jobs.
Yeah.
But Def Comedy Jam, that's my main shit.
And Atlanta's lit.
Yeah, man. Oh, just start doing heavy black rooms. Like, if I can make a black dude like run away.
Getting up a lot more. That'd be the cool part too. Getting up a lot more in a lot of different spaces.
Yeah. I want to
So the goal is to go there to do comedy, not to go there to live.
I mean, yeah, I mean, it's both.
I mean, of course you're going to be living where you're going. But
comedy, man.
You're going to be live.
Comedy.
Yeah.
All the time.
But comedy is the reason to go, for sure.
Yeah. If I can get like, I've seen some dudes like destroy black rooms. I'm like, that's, I mean, like, you have fun sometimes. Like, you see like a master do it. I'm like, yo, when I get to that level, bro, then I'm like, okay, now what's the next step? But I want to get to that fucking, like, make niggas run away type shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's like, bro, or make somebody cry type shit.
Yeah.
I've done both of those things once in my entire
like thing. Cry laughing or cry because you're roasting them.
Oh, cry laughing.
Yeah.
Cry laughing. I mean, I don't mind the way cry because I roast them. I don't know. Like, you're kind of fucking me up right now. Yeah, I was joking. I'm joking. Yeah. I'm a comedian. What are you doing here?
Yeah. I mean, am I hitting on some real shit? Do you need to talk to somebody?
Yeah. This is, I got a therapist.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that's my main shit. Yeah, Def Comedy Jam.
You want to be in movies, Micah?
I don't know. I'd like to fucking make a movie, man. I'd like to. Making a movie, I wouldn't even have to, like, write it. If someone just let me help make it, like, hey, I'll fucking carry something. What's up? Let me fucking write this thing. Let me act in it. You know what I mean? I would love to, like, I don't know, just, like, help create something, like, bigger than myself that's different from stand-up, too, though. You know what I mean? Sure.
Why not write a screenplay and like, and shoot a low budget movie, indie movie?
Yeah, no, that is a good idea.
That's a good resume.
We should do that. We should do that.
Don't project onto me.
I mean, all right, I should do that, but I would. I mean, if I would have anyone to do it with, I'd be like, hey, JD, look at this thing. I don't know.
Because it was like, yeah, I'm like, he's like, all right, man, we need dates. I'm like, man, I'm tired. Right. Yeah. I'll help out when everything's set up. But I'm like,
you're the bunch of bullshit.
I was like, bro, I'll show up and like help. But I'm like, I ain't trying to plan nothing.
I mean, that's an aspect up of writing.
That's fucked up.
I'm letting you know.
It's like we're a squad, but it's like really not, though.
We a squad, but everybody's got a different mission. That's the strong squad.
But if you needed some help, I would help you. And I wouldn't be like, hey, get it all ready, and I'll just try to, like, wing it when I get there.
Bro, but I'm saying, like, when I get on Def Comedy Jam, I'm like, Micah, show up, please, help, laugh. Like, that's my main shit.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying?
All right.
Like, when you get everything, you're like, I got a crew together. I'm like, nigga, I guess I'm showing up. This nigga got a goddamn crew together. Got a light guy, a mic guy, fucking actors and shit. I'm like, all right, I'm showing up.
Wow, that's terrible. I mean, like, you know what I mean?
And I'm being helped, bro, and I'm working hard for the
because
whole day.
I would do way more for you. You realize that? That's what I'm saying. I would be like, what jokes are you going to do? Like, what do you think about this? I think what you should wear. I would be like, if you did the Def Con, I would try to help on any level I could.
Hey, bro, I'd go real simple on that shit, bro. Black t-shirt, jeans, you know what I'm saying?
Just, and I'd be like, nigga, why?
And some Tims.
Nigga, why? Yeah, I'll never wear Tims.
I'm like, dead ass, B. I need these Tims. Wow. I would do an accent for the whole thing.
Yeah.
Do a character
on God, nah, my dude.
On God, nigga. But but I mean, I don't know. I just feel like when I got it, I'm like, I got this shit the JD way. It's just gonna work out.
So you don't want help from anybody.
I'm saying, you know, I mean, but it's just like I learned.
Just fuck all your friends.
I learned this is a introspective type thing. Okay. I learned the most when I'm going through it by myself because I'll try dumb shit.
I know.
You know what
I
saying?
Watch that happen. That's why.
I'll try dumb shit. I'm like, all right, don't do that. I learned through fucking up. I gotta fuck up.
Yeah.
I won't get stronger.
But no, but it's like, but not only do you learn from fucking up, you also nig any type of like help or guidance along the way.
That ain't true. When I get frustrated, I'm like, okay, I'm fucked up a lot. I'll ask for help. I'm like, let me keep. If I'm still fucking up, I'm like, I need to do this. Like, that's my brain. I'm like, if I'm still fucking up, I still believe there's a chance I can figure it out.
I think the core difference between me and you is I'm constantly like, I don't need to do anything that's not the absolute best way to do it. First try. Like, I need to.
Nigga.
Let me think about this enough before I even attempt it to where I just kill it. And that
trial
also,
by fire.
That also hinders me. So sometimes with writing, I'll work up like writing is such an important thing that I won't write. I'm like, because I'm like, I want to write right now, but I'm like, I'm not in the mood to write some fire, so I'm just going to be bullshit, so I won't write. You know what I mean? Even though I know if I just get the pen and paper out, I'll just start getting loose and it'll just happen.
Get on that phone, man.
True.
I'll type anything. I went back to some old shit. I was like, man, no, none of this makes sense.
Yeah. Yeah, I should take some. I think we should take from a little yin and yang from each other.
I'm doing it. I'm going to. I was like, you know what Michael would do? Michael, I watched you lose all that weight on your Facebook thing. That's legit. Yeah. One of the milestones. I was like, this nigga lost all this weight just fucking playing drums.
Yeah. It was a lot of work, though.
What am I doing? Very hard. Yeah, I hear you. But I mean, like, you're playing drums, but, like, you're also, like, running a lot and shit like that. But I'm still, yeah, like.
But it's pretty physical.
But I was like, you're working out. I was like, he was doing something he liked.
Sure.
And he lost weight doing it. Sure. And I was like, man, what am I doing? I was like, I liked working out back when it was easier, when I was lighter. You know what I'm saying? When I was lighter, I was like, this ain't that bad.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because you feel good walking and shit like
sure,
that.
Sure, yeah.
And then, you know, shit just happens. But now I'm trying to make myself like it again. I'm like, it's a dark analogy, but I'm like, imagine if you quit the gym, it's like suicide. Like straight up. So I just can't stop. I'm like, I can easily stop. This, I'm like, if you stop this, you can stop life. I'm like, if I ain't trying to stop life, so I'm trying to just fucking. I made it that serious for myself.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
But it's been working.
You really raised the stakes on yourself.
I had to, bro. I wouldn't go.
Yeah, I feel
like. If I was doing this for any other reason, I would have stopped. I would have stopped by now. Yeah. That's just terrible when you're going.
Yeah, but in a way that you're actually adding to your life. So
you're right.
There are life and death
consequences. I twisted my darkness into like choice. Helping me. That's my biggest thing.
Good.
And depression can't keep up. Depression's fat, man. It's crazy. It's so fucking fat.
So you can slim your way out of depression?
I be on the elliptical, and depression's like, you ain't shit. I'm like, nigga, you ain't shit. you back there, nigga. Keep up.
Yeah.
He's like, man, let's go eat some fucking Doritos and smoke a blunt. I'm like, nigga, I gotta finish. Yeah. He'll be like, I'll be back. And I'm like, all right. But it's just like he's getting smaller and smaller. He's still there, though. The nigga's like, man, you need one bad thing to happen, nigga. And I promise the guy. I got hit with a fucking light bill the other day, nigga. Like a double. Like, you ain't paid in like 2 months type shit. The pressure was like, what's up? What's up, nigga? What's up? You ain't yeah. shit, nigga. You ain't paying light bills, nigga. What's up? I'm going to blow up on your ass.
Did you forget or something? What happened?
I need to be forgetting. Yeah. They don't like. Duke Energy's like, they nice about this shit. They don't even say nothing. They be like, he going through some things. Yeah. And then they sent me the bill. They're like, man, just pay a little bit of it. You know what I'm saying? Keep your shit on. Whatever. Yeah.
Damn. That's a little bit. Just getting to
it's like, man, you know what I'm saying? Pay 1 month or whatever. Keep your shit on. You know what I'm saying? We ain't no big deal. Ain't tripping. But just
keep
like,
it on double for a while.
But they was like, I got it in the mail. And I got my mail late. Like, I don't take my mail like that. And then they're like, and then I still had time. They're like, yeah, man, a couple weeks or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Just fucking, you know, get that to us.
Yeah, just give us a little something.
Duke Energy's kind of cool. Time Warner, ain't and fucking.
Spectrum, they got a new name. Like, new name.
Like, fuck this apartment complex. They're like, yeah, we got mandatory cable now. I was like, nigga, I don't want your punk ass 30 channels. I got, like, what the, like, that is,
they that's made just you some, buy cable.
Everybody. They're like, everybody got cable now. And I was like, we
did
don't want
it. Did you plug
it
in, though, at least?
No. I'm like, I got Netflix. I got all this shit. Yeah. But that's like that money evil I'm talking about. Yeah. They're like, man, make these, we need some more something. So, like, add a luxury, but make them have a luxury that they're not going to use. What the fuck am I watching on cable? Like, some woodworking shit? Like, Judge Judy?
Viceland's pretty cool. I don't know if
that's on HBO.
That's not on HBO.
It is Vice. I mean,
it is on Vice is on HBO, but Viceland's a channel.
You know, YouTube or something.
I don't know if it's on regular cable.
Aren't they on everything though? Like on YouTube, HBO.
Viceland can't stop. Can't stop, won't stop. Diddy mentality.
What's going on with you, bro?
I'm chilling. I'm coming up on some jobs.
Nice.
I have. Talked my way through to being kind of an after school middle school teacher.
What?
Yeah, right? Yeah.
Good stuff.
Yeah, I'm excited. But it's also weird because it's like, you know, I was in middle school and I did after school programs and there was people that came and taught and I'm like, did they live my lifestyle? Because
yep.
That's kind of cool.
I'm going to get a job at Staples and go through the ranks.
Don't do that, JD.
No, it's too late.
JD, dude. Oh, my God. Dude, that is classic not valuing yourself. That is classic normal
bruh,
Pokemon yourself.
I can destroy a staple. What are you talking about?
But you can destroy.
Dude, when you're the manager, you make the schedule, you never work in days you don't want to work.
Dude.
Think about it.
JD, this is Will you maybe chime in this? I think JD obviously has he has some work experience for sure, and that he could get a job higher than I think you apply for. I think if you apply for like stores or like retail, but like I don't know. In my mind, you could work at a job that handles more money just by the job, what it does, and you could finesse and just you'd be in a bigger money bracket just by handling and dealing with more money.
Bro, I feel you on that, but a nigga need health insurance.
People give health insurance, man.
I mean, I'm looking at jobs like colleges and banks, but like right now, Staples is like, yo, we need niggas that sell, and I'm like, I'm a nigga that sells.
Did you need to work? Why not be a college reporter? Dude, for real.
I mean, I ain't taught that dude yet.
Yeah, you need to. He said something like 56.
I ain't trying to tell no old lady that her fucking insurance got cut off, nigga.
It's people that already said they wanted life insurance. That's what he does.
Hey, Miss Jenkins, you don't qualify. Hey, Miss Jenkins, you lost it. I'm just like, I don't know. I'll talk to the nigga, though. But just like, I ain't like telling niggas their mattress is going to be late. So I don't know I'm going to tell no nigga, like, you can't get this fucking insurance plan for your family or whatever.
Dude, I mean, you might not kind of like that, but I mean, it's like real dough.
Bro, see, you the nigga that recruits. You the recruiter that fucking gets you the
job. I'm
not
even doing it, but I'm just, maybe it's just I believe in you, JD. I'll just say it, I believe
in you. Bro, I mean, I look at that job. I look at other options, too. I can say that.
Yeah, I think you're better than Staples.
Sounds like it pays more than Staples.
I feel like you're better than Staples.
Staples be paying a little bit of stacks. You get high up in the ranks, though, but it's just you gotta put a little bit of work in.
Okay, maybe I'm dumb. Maybe I'm dumb.
I'm trying to, my thing is like, I'm trying to find a job that's low-key as shit. I don't never see Staples busy, bro. When last time you seen Staples packed?
School time and stuff.
All right, that's it. Like, fucking maybe like 3 weeks.
It's a personality difference. You're seeking stability. He's seeking a quick fix to hold him over until comedy blows up.
I don't need a career. I just need a job.
No, you're doing shit with a group.
I mean, a career with comedy, but I'm like, right now, I know I can destroy that shit. And I'll be fucking, that'll be my come up story. Like, you know, JD worked at Staples until fucking, if I become like high up and I'm fucking like making bank
You already got that story with Mattress Firm. That's what I'm saying. Staples don't do nothing to you.
I already talked about Mattress Firm. that's like a one night stand with corporation. I don't want to fucking deal with that shit. But I know what I'm getting into.
You don't think the niggas that own Mattress Firm own Staples?
Oh, shit. Oh, goddamn. If we're being real, shit was being bought and sold a lot. And we were asking questions and not getting many answers. At some point, we were a West African company. Really? And then that shit transferred to Germany. What? And then back to the States.
Dude, that's what I'm saying. They're just pinballing that shit around fucking fake money.
But you know at one point I was making bank, though. We were talking about it.
Dude, I talked to somebody the other day about working at Mattress Firm. They're like, a buddy of mine just started working there, and he's making, like, real paper. And I'm like, that's Greensboro East Market. Imagine if it was Greensboro West.
No, Greensboro West Market, that's where all the money is.
Oh.
Greensboro East ain't shit. The Greensboro East is pretty much Greensboro, like a little bit of Virginia, but like this is trash. This is garbage. This is garbage. And there's no money to be made in the mattress game in Greensboro. All right. This ship. That's my PSA.
The market dried up.
The market's dead, bro. You could be at a store in Greensboro the same day, do 500, sell a punk ass cuck bed, like a fucking trash ass bed. It's fucking garbage. And then another store, fucking same day and everything in Winston, it's like, yeah, we just dropped $25,000. I'm like, nigga, who did you talk to?
Yeah.
Who? Bro, but like, that's a real thing you can get, but like, who bought that?
Yeah.
And that was on a consistent basis. One store is projected to do like, one store does over $1 million, I think, each year. Mm-hmm. Just like the Labor Day sale we had, they probably did like maybe 100,000 like that.
That's crazy.
It's stupid. Like, I'm not, like, that's what opened my eyes to retail and sales. I was like, niggas are really. I've never seen money flow like that. I mean, I guess if you work in a bank, you see shit like that. But, like, as far as a mattress shit, I'm like, what the fuck?
You know where I feel like you'd work great at? A fucking Best Buy. If you're going to work for a corporation.
But then I'd probably, I don't know.
I feel like Geek Squad like hell.
Hell no. Nah, I ain't doing no Geek Squad. The niggas don't know nothing. The niggas be fucking.
Do you know anything?
No, but I don't want to not know nothing and then be faking like I know something. I don't want to do that shit. I want to tell you what I know. I know them niggas do. Them niggas fucking, you say something's wrong with your computer, they fucking reboot the whole shit.
Your shit got deleted. We don't know how that happened.
They reboot the whole shit. They cut in a little clipboard and shit. Like, yeah, we had to do a system wipe.
Yeah.
And then they give you shit back to you.
We did it immediately. It was weird.
That's like the first thing they do. They wipe your whole shit and see if it fixed anything.
Yeah.
Well, that's one way to do
it. After that, they call their corporate and like have somebody walk them through it.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, yo, this dude's computer's really fucked up. We wiped the whole thing and it still got a pop-up and shit.
Yeah, that was a really weird marketing campaign. Hey, you know those fucking losers at your high school? We fucking wrangled a bunch of them and they're going to fucking fix your shit.
Don't come to your house and install your computer
on command. Come to our fucking store. We have them on command. We have geeks.
And I'm like, bro, don't display the perfect Geek Squad member on TV and then give me like the fucking
purple hair.
Yeah, he's like, bro, nope, shirt not even tucked in.
Yeah.
I'm like, what's the commitment?
You know, Best Buy Geeks, that's why I say Geek Squad, because they do seem like we're not Best Buy. That's their whole vibe over there. Like, we're Geek Squad.
I want to.
We're a squad. We have cars.
I don't know. I need something like a commission. I don't need no commission at Best Buy.
Commission at Staples?
A little bit of commission at Staples. I think, like,
John. What are you going to get a commission on? Like,
Staples.
That's what I'm saying.
That's fucked up, then.
Like, what's the commission on Staples?
Hey, nigga, I'm about to find out.
You realize you're going to be in there, they're going to have like a soundtrack playing. Right. That alone.
It was a soundtrack at Magic Spire.
I don't know. Something about that makes me be like, I'm at some point going to have to come here with a handgun. I'm going to have to do that. That's not like, just that there's like constant, like the same loop of music playing every day. Can't happen. I'm going to lose my mind.
Not going to trance, man. It's like something kind of soothing about it. Just like when nothing's going on, I'm like, man.
It depends on, man, it depends on what they're playing. There's a bunch of Christian rock. I don't know the fuck.
Christian rock?
I don't know. Sometimes you go to Staples on a Sunday.
I would change that station.
The wrong man.
But see, if I work there, I know what's going on. I'm changing shit. I'm making shit kind of cool.
Yeah.
I'm playing a little Uzi Vert sometimes.
You never playing that.
Sometimes. So on Fridays. It do not matter. Yeah, I'm playing a little bit of that. I don't know. I believe in it, man. I need to pay rent and save money. That's all I need to do.
I'm hating.
Yeah.
I just need to pay rent and save money. If something come up, I'll come up and I'll fucking take that shit, but.
You got to do what you got to do.
Right now, a nigga needs, I need money. Fuck the perfect job. A nigga needs money. I ain't trying to fast food. I know that. But sales or anything fucking retail, I'm in there.
I feel that.
If you got a job, period, man.
I try to get a job in sales.
Making cash.
Bruh.
That's what I'm talking about. Like an area.
I dealt with so many drug dealers in Madison Farm, it made no sense.
But what he's saying is kind of true. You don't have a degree. You can work at the places you're choosing, but there's a whole different category of jobs you could be aiming at.
Yeah.
Maybe it's a little bit more competitive and the rules of getting it are a little different, but
yeah, you gotta play
the game. Outcome is going to be more stability.
And more worth your time.
Yes.
You're right.
That's why you spent these years in school.
Yeah, you know what I mean? And honestly, it's at the point to where it's like, not only do you need to earn money, but also your time is valuable. You know what I mean? Because it could be time you're going to a mic or writing or doing any of these other things, what you really want to do. So that's my end goal. These jobs kind of worked out. I basically have two teaching gigs where it's like a kind of part-time, like about 18 hours a week doing this after-school program, but I also teach private lessons with this music place or whatever. So what I really want to do at some point is to find passive income. That's how you fucking make real money.
Bro, talk about it.
YouTube videos.
That's how you get wealth.
Where you don't trade your time for money. That's what I want to get to, where it's like, I just provide like some type of service or some type of entertainment, something that I could, you know.
We're in an era where you can and almost have to do that.
Yeah.
I mean, y'all look at Issa Rae. Do y'all watch Insecure?
Yeah.
I need to start watching it.
Man, that is a funny ass show.
That show's good.
But she started as an online web presence, man. Like, that's
yeah, there's a lot of shows on HBO like that. Broad City shit was like that.
That's real.
Yeah.
That is, I mean, I teach that this moment is unique in that you have the ability to create culture and disseminate it to a mass audience.
That's some shit I actually wouldn't mind to do. That's some shit I would love to do.
to do some shit, to blow up online, get some clout, and then get really paid to do it.
The only scary part about it is we have the potential of creating a dystopia like in Max Headroom, like where everybody was filming each other all day.
Yeah.
And all we did was sit there and watch TV of people who are filming people on TV. It's like this real weird ass loop.
Yeah.
People are all disconnected from each other. Kind of like now, but
I was about to say that happened like 2 summers ago. We're there.
Yeah, it's all right. We already in that.
Well, I mean, since we are there, I mean, what you got to start looking at yourselves as comedians a little different. I mean, you have a chance. You don't have to wait to get on. In a certain respect, you can put yourself on. You can do like you're doing now and like develop your own community of listeners.
Yeah. We live,
baby.
That's
the goal, man.
That's the goal. What do you want to wrap up on?
UCC starting up.
UCC starting up. Ultimate Comic Challenge.
You guys both going to make it again this year?
I don't know, man.
Don't put that on my mind. Don't.
Yeah, we're just going
to. I mean, y'all can. It was like, what was it, the 1-3 punch? No, the 2-3 punch?
2-3 yeah, punch. Yeah. I don't know. I've been thinking about it. Last year making the finals was incredible. Getting second place was incredible. That was so awesome. I definitely didn't expect that. And, I mean, literally for this year to be better, quote unquote, I mean, because I also had a great set. Like, I really enjoyed myself. For it to be better, quote unquote, I would have to win the whole thing. So the probability of that happening is small. I mean, what are the chances I win the whole thing?
If you wear a suit, you'll win. You said it last year, and I'm going to say it again. You wear a suit or a jacket, you'll win. Damn. Guaranteed. Ethos. Wow.
He do be saying this shit.
Wow. Yeah, damn. That's on some too woke for my mind shit. But my thing is, I'm just trying to have fun this year. I'm already preparing myself. It's going to be pretty hard for this year to be better than last year. You know what I mean? So I'm just going to try to have fun and do some
good stuff. That's what I'm saying. How can it be better other than your presentation of yourself?
True.
In a public speaking moment that is designed to be a capstone moment for the organization.
That would have been tight to really like do
it. If I get to the finals again, if I get to a theater again for competition, I will wear a suit jacket.
Honestly, that was a strange thing going into it because you'd been on the podcast being like, if I make it to the finals again, I'm bow tie.
Yeah, nigga had money, his dreams.
I'm a fucking, I'm gonna be do it so big.
No, then it's just like, nah.
I mean, it's a show off moment. Why not show off?
If that ever happens again. If that, you know.
You know, honestly, what it is, it's like, that does make sense, but a lot of it, for me, I was like, it's going to be so uncomfortable. I've never been on stage that big, and it's going to be so different. Personally, I want to do whatever it makes me feel comfortable. I feel like I look nice in what I'm wearing. This is something I would wear on stage. This is me. I got to go with me.
I always think of things rhetorically, and I think of public speech and presence. I understand you have to do what's comfortable for you. But in public moments, presentation matters.
Yeah, maybe.
And I mean, that's not me saying that. That's just the way the human mind works.
Yeah.
And you're trying to sway people into liking you or presenting the best form.
And maybe it's my own insecurity.
Your mama made you wear a suit to church for a reason.
Yeah. Maybe it's my own insecurity coming out that, like, in my head a little bit, I was like, if I fucking, I don't want to wear a suit. And it seemed like the joke is that I'm wearing a suit.
Why not?
You know what I mean? Like, it's like, why would this dude be what? Yeah, I don't know. I feel that. All right. Hey, that sounds good. I'll make the finals again, baby. We're going to be suited up.
Suited and booted.
We're going to be fucking.
If that happens. You know what I'm saying? We out here. Things are happening.
I'm not worried about it, man. It's just fucking. The shows are going to be fun. That's what I'm excited. Mine's actually, I think, Friday.
Yeah, mine. Is it Friday?
The 15th, this Friday?
I guess I got to watch that.
Is that next Friday? It's the late show.
And that's this Friday, right?
Yeah, it's this Friday.
I'll check that out.
I don't even know what jokes I'm going to do.
Don't matter, man. We present, bro. We present.
Are we? Okay. What do you want to wrap up on?
Why can't you ask me that?
I don't know.
What do you wear for more?
Thanks for listening. If you've ever listened to any other episode, if this is your first episode, thanks for listening. Y'all the shit. 100 episodes is awesome. I'm really proud of this.
This has been a journey, man.
Share this. If we've ever made you laugh this episode or any other episode, fucking tell somebody. You don't have to, you know, get your way, do anything crazy. Share it with a friend.
And fucking talk to us.
Let somebody know.
Somebody say something.
Also, you know, you know, the United States, we always say that. There actually is a guy that's in the Charlotte scene that emailed us that we haven't responded. I don't even know if you've seen it. He's emailed us.
He has?
And he, like, was, yeah, and he's been really kind, and I would shout out his name, but I'm high and I don't remember right now. But I'm going to respond to your email.
All right, please do.
I'm going to do that.
I had no idea nigga emailed us.
I know, because you don't even check the email.
But well, I checked the email. I mean,
because normally it's nobody like, ever does. Exactly. Like, why I realized I someone it? had did do it like 3 months ago, and then I figured that out. I figured that out like 3.5 weeks ago, and I haven't responded yet. I read the message, and I
thought about it. He's hearing this right now. He's fucking bastard.
I thought about it, and I just hadn't. Somebody that we had on, I think Juwan mentioned his name.
Yeah,
and
he
like,
did,
and was like, he wants to be on, dude. We're gonna connect you. You can be on for sure.
Yeah, thanks
for
listening. Dude. If you say you want to get on, and you fucking wait 3 months, we got you, bro.
We got you.
You guys are going to build your audience and then hire somebody to do that.
Yeah. Hey, that's goals. Boom. What song do you want to end on?
Oh, yeah.
No Complaints by Metro Boomin.
Okay.
Okay. Hell yeah.
All right. Hell yeah. Well, thank you guys for listening. Episode 100.
Appreciate it, man. We love you guys.
We out. Hey, thanks for listening to another episode of the Open Micers Podcast.
And listen, if you need to find us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, it is at The Open Micers. And for bookings or general questions, it's theopenmicers@gmail.com.
And if you guys are listening on iTunes, please, please, please go rate and review. Rate and review is the easiest way for the podcast to grow and get more people to listen.
Yeah, and like, you know, just follow your dreams, nigga, you know?
Yeah, just in general, you got a dream. Do that shit. Do that shit. Thanks.
Ain't no complaints.
Nah.
Rex in the bank.
Rex.
Fuck what you think.
Huh?
We got some rank.
Rank.
Leo S. Thang.
Wow.
Robbing the bank.
Bang.
Pull out the bank.
Wow.
You was a stranger.
Stranger.
We don't relate.
No.
Rex in the.
Rex.
Rex in the safe.
Safe.
Steak on my plate.
Steak.
My sons are done.
Done.
My bitch Amazon.
Bang.
My plug is hung.
Also,
she fucking for sons.
Bang.
I wanna be like Muhammad Ali.
Hey.
Hang on the ropes and I beat you to sleep.
Hey.
Talk to get money cause talk is too cheap.
Cheap.
Quarter million when you open my brief. Celebrity status, so keep this shit brief. Draco by me cause I keep it in reach. No nigga didn't do that shit like that boy me.
Nah.
Just word on the street, let me preach, let me preach. Listen, little nigga, sometimes you don't speak. Pull out that stick and I'm sweeping the street.
Bah.
I make a quarter million every week.
Hey.
She sucked out my soul, it's making me weak.
Woo.
I've been on Percocets for the last week.
Hey.
Sipping on lean, I'm sleep.
Geek.
Move out the way, beat. Riding the waves to see deep. Ain't no complaints.
Nah.
Rex in the bank.
Rex.
For what you think.
Huh?
We got some rank.
Rank.
Leo S. Thang.
Wow.
Robbing the bank.
Bang.
Pull out the bank.
Wow.
You was a stranger.
Stranger.
We don't relate.
No.
Rex in the.
Rack.
Rex in the safe.
Safe.
Steak on my plate.
Steak.
My sons are done.
Done.
My bitch Amazon.
Bang.
My plug is hun, she fucking for son.
At 17, I wanted everything that was in store. At 23, I bought it all just to make sure.
Yeah, yeah.
Fuck a delay,
yeah.
They gotta pay,
yeah.
Like it's back in the day.
Hey.
Racks in the,
what?
Racks in the safe.
Safe.
Look in my face, up there with the greats. Steps that I take, you can't retrace. Yo, Metro on bass. Me, I'm just bass. Can't afford no mistakes. Everything just in case. Billboard where I play. They welcome me, I overstayed. I'm a huncho, I'm the boss. Mindset taking off. Polo used to be Lacoste. Water used to be the tap, nigga, not the boss. Damn, things change. I'm so awake. You take the bait. You get replaced. You do the math, nigga. On 88 days, the take home is crazy. I take home your baby. Yeah.
Ain't no complaints.
Nah.
Rex in the bank.
Rex.
For what you think.
Huh?
We got some rank.
Rank.
Leo S. Thang.
Wow.
Robbing the bank.
Bang.
Pull out the bank.
Wow.
You was a stranger.
Stranger.
We don't relate.
No.
Rex in the.
Rack.
Rex in the safe.
Safe.
Steak on my plate.
Steak.
My sons are done.
Done.
My bitch Amazon.
Bang.
My plug is hun.
Plug.
She fucking for son.
23, I bought it all just to make sure.